prepare to go.
It's time to get things started.
On the most sensational, inspirational, celebrational, Keelerational. This is what we call the Keeler Show.
Now back to Keeler.
Hello, I'd like to vote for president, governor, and anything that will take money away from our parks and libraries.
Go vote now. It'll make you feel big and strong.
WIBX 950 and 106.9 FM. The Keeler Show.
Hello, 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 hello.
How you
hello,
doing?
Hello.
How you doing? How you
hello.
Doing?
Hello. Hello. Well, it's Wednesday morning. It's already March. Can you believe it's March 27th?
I cannot.
Can you believe that, let's see, the first day of April is going to be Monday, right?
April Fool's Day.
April Fool's Day is Monday. And Easter Sunday is, you guessed it, Sunday. Tomorrow is Thursday. And then Friday is Good Friday. Wow. I've got it all in my head now.
Yes, you do.
Today is also National Viagra Day.
Oh, good.
But Viagra for women, there is a thing.
Oh, geez.
Wake up.
Apparently, yeah.
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy, says Davey. Oh, boy. Papa's going to be busy. Oh, boy. We have so much to get to here today. Brandon Williams, the congressman, has a take on this this Baltimore bridge. I want to get right into that. We'll do that this morning. Ryan Nobles is on from NBC. He was covering the bridge collapse. Also, Rona McDaniel. It'll be an interesting take. Employees there were up in arms that NBC was hiring her, and now they've reversed the hire.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
I didn't hear that part.
Yeah.
Are you serious?
Yes, they have unhired her.
Wow.
Yeah.
Is it because of her appearance on Meet the Press on Sunday?
I do not know what all of this is about, except that she's... Go ahead.
Chuck Todd kind of ripped into her on...
Was he filling in?
Yeah, he was filling in for Kristen Walker on Sunday.
And he went after her.
Wow,
yeah.
That's...
She was one of the guest analysts on the panel.
Okay, I'll have to look at that and see what it is. Ryan Schmell is also on this morning on the bridge collapse in Baltimore. He's from Baltimore. So it'll be interesting to see what his take is. New facility planned in Oneida Square for the Utica Fire Department. We'll speak with Utica Chief Scott Ingersoll. Legal expert Andrew Reed, we'll get that in this morning. There is a new Mohawk Valley Crime Stoppers Wanted Person of the Week up on our website. We won't get to that officially till tomorrow, but it's up there and you can check it out. Police are looking for that person. Brandon Williams, Congressman, NY22. How vulnerable are we? His take on the bridge. I was on in London.
Yesterday
on talk TV is what they call it, and radio, and that is Piers Morgan's network in London, and I was because they were asking questions about the bridge collapse, and you know that we have our own bridge collapse here that was devastating, and it happened back in the 80s on the thruway. If you remember that, and still to this day, every time I go over that bridge and look down into that huge drop down into the creek that goes in underneath that. That was much like I'm pretty sure it was a spring day. I don't really remember, but I was on my way back from an event down in Wells Bridge. I was working in country music at the time.
Wow.
And there was a country show. John Schneider, I think, or somebody was playing down there, and we were down driving back, and I was going to take my girlfriend back to Albany at the Albany School of Pharmacy, and we decided to stay one more day at home, and then the next day we're unable to get take the thruway out to there. I believe that's how it went down.
Wow.
It's been a few years. The story may have varied a little bit, but I can tell you I was supposed to be on the bridge that day. We chose not to be there. We went either the day before or the day after, and then that bridge collapse occurred. And I will tell you, getting home was almost impossible because the thruway was shut down, And then, but beyond that, you had problems with Route 5 right there and 5S. Yeah. All the traffic, it was just a giant traffic jam getting home.
Well, and I can't imagine what it's like even still this morning and yesterday and what will be into today down in Baltimore, having to redirect a lot of that traffic. And
is it true that no cars went off?
My understanding was...
six people are now considered perished. They're construction workers. But
I don't know that any of the vehicles, because I think first responders were able to, based on the audio I heard, stop traffic when they saw the cargo ship approaching.
All right, here's how.
But the big thing is, too, I just want to say, too, what's going to impact, we'll talk to Ryan about this.
So they saw it approaching. I believe what we're hearing is the thing lost power, and it was
drifting.
A few
different times.
Yeah, and it was drifting, and they lost control of it. And so the people on the bridge, dispatchers, saw there was a problem, stopped traffic. Wow.
And the big factor here, too, is that Baltimore's port there, where ships go in and out of, is one of the biggest on the East Coast.
It is one of the biggest when it comes to automobiles.
Yeah.
The thousands of and shipping into the into around the rest of the country, automobiles come through there. So. Major bridge in Baltimore, the Francis Scott Key Bridge, partially collapsed early yesterday morning after it was hit by a 948-foot dolly cargo ship. Bronner Builders Incorporated had a construction crew on the bridge fixing potholes when it collapsed. A building company executive said this evening that six of its employees are now presumed dead. Two people who had been plunged into the river were rescued. One is in serious condition. The other refused medical treatment. Here's the governor of Maryland, Wes Moore, from his press conference and audio from that from yesterday. And here it is.
Our state is in shock. To our first responders, I'm in awe of you. You saw a crisis, and you said, what can I do to help? And our response teams are doing everything in our power to rescue and recover the victims of this collapse, literally as we speak. All of our hearts are broken. We feel your loss, but Maryland, we will get through this, because that is the Maryland spirit, and that's what Maryland is made of. We are Maryland tough, and we are Baltimore strong.
So Interstate I-695 goes over that river, the Patapsco River.
Yeah.
Here's the governor continuing about the devastating loss of the Key Bridge.
So many of us know the Key Bridge because it is our normal commute. This is a place that is a normal commute route for over 30,000 Marylanders every single day. And so to hear the words that the Key Bridge has collapsed, it's shocking and heartbreaking. But for every single one of us who are Marylanders, the words that the Key Bridge is gone, it still shakes us. Because for 47 years, that's all we've known. It's heartbreaking.
You know, that's going to take months and months and months. And the question is, I guess the thing that should make us all nervous is it takes one ship to take out one pillar to take down the entire bridge.
Yeah.
Wow.
Well, it's an older bridge. I mean, that begs the question: how long it gone without maintenance? Is there deferred maintenance?
And how many other bridges in the country are we facing the same problem with? Here is the Maryland governor, Wes Moore, talking about the importance of the May Day that actually saved lives.
You know, we had a ship that was coming in at 8 knots, so coming in at a very rapid speed. You know, once the warning came up and once notification came up that there was a May Day, literally by being able to stop cars from coming over the bridge, these people are heroes. They saved lives last night.
That's what didn't happen on the New York State Thruway back in the 80s, right? Because cars were just driving, and it's kind of an uphill. You're going uphill on that bridge, so, and then downhill if you were going westbound. So you got to be thinking, you're flying, you're not paying attention. All of a sudden you look and the road is gone. The bridge is gone. And there was flooding at that time, which is what eroded the supports on that bridge. But in this case, they were able to stop people. It was actually emergency communication to stop all traffic from the bridge. More lives would have been lost if not for the emergency workers. Here it is.
We advised the entire Key Bridge in the harbor. I advised to hold all traffic from coming to the bridge. I advise again, the entire Key Bridge has fallen into the harbor.
Units responding on rescue alarm I-695. Be advised, the entire Key Bridge has now collapsed into the water. The entire Key Bridge has now collapsed into the water. Proceed with caution.
Now, I don't know how they I've never been over this bridge. So I don't know how they actually do this there. Is there a toll? Is that why there are active people working at the bridge? Again, not to keep going back to the bridge on the state thruway, but no one attended to that bridge. That was just a bridge along the thruway. You don't even realize it's a bridge when you're going over it. Here, I wonder if it sounds like there were active people there.
Yeah,
and
in the area.
Construction and construction that was going on to be able to get there quickly and stop traffic from coming in.
Well, especially with it being a port, you know, much like an air traffic controller.
Yeah,
I think there has to be probably somebody directing that ship traffic.
You're right. It was a quick response from the Baltimore Bridge Dispatch, which there is such a thing. So luckily there was such a thing there that helped save lives by quickly communicating that all traffic had to be stopped on both sides of the Key Bridge. Here's the dramatic communication as they work on that. As soon as they heard there was a problem with not just the bridge going in, when they heard there was a problem with the cargo ship, it was this advanced communication that actually saved all the lives.
One of you guys on the south side, one of you guys on the north side, hold all traffic on the Key Bridge. There's a ship approaching that just lost their steering. So until you get that under control, we got to stop all traffic.
Army route to the south side.
Yeah, if we can stop traffic, just make sure no one's on the bridge right now. There's a crew up there. You might want to notify whoever the foreman is, see if we can get them off the bridge temporarily.
10-4, once the other unit gets here, I'll ride up on the bridge.
C-13 dispatch, the whole bridge just fell down. Everybody, the whole bridge just collapsed.
Do we know if all traffic will stop?
I can't get to the other side, sir. The bridge is down.
C-13, I'm holding all traffic northbound.
Wow. If that doesn't give you chills, I don't know if anything will. That's something. That audio is something to hear.
Yeah. This is coming from our man, Ed Welsh. Andrew, the biggest question regarding the bridge accident is why the giant freighter was not towed out of the harbor via tugboat. I thought that was normal procedure.
You see it in the New York Harbor all the time, right? When one of those boats is they're being tugged. Yeah. I guess that's the reason for it. I did not realize it. If we can grab Ryan Schmelz right now, it would be a good time.
Well, why don't we take a break? Because I got to figure out what's going on with that.
All right. I'll do as you say. But just an accident that could have been so much worse, and an accident that has got to open our eyes to the potential that this could very well be a terrorist target. And if it isn't, I don't know how it isn't, and I hope we're doing something to keep people safe, not at just this location, but around the country. Quick break. We'll come right back. It's 6:38 at WIBX.
And what helps us do that? Getting our flu shot, the updated COVID vaccine. Yeah, we stay on top of these things so that we can do the things that we love with the people we love, because we don't want to miss out.
A message from the New York State Department of Health.
Dog parents are loving Dr. Marty's Nature's Blend premium dog food.
The way she acts and the way she moves, it's just so much better. And she actually, she's like a puppy again. It's unbelievable.
Dr. Marty's Nature's Blend is a freeze-dried raw food made with zero artificial preservatives. So it's naturally shelf-stable with no mess, freezer, or fridge required. Plus, it's full of premium turkey, beef, salmon, and meat your dog will love.
We started with Nature's Blend. She's happy. She sleeps well. She's energetic. I am just delighted with this product.
When given the choice, Nature's Blend and Amazon's number one bestseller in dry dog food, 29 out of 30 dogs chose Nature's Blend first.
I am so confident your dog will love it. Your order is backed with a 90-day guarantee.
Save up to 54% off Nature's Blend and get a free bag of delicious beef liver treats. Go to drmartypets.com/deal or text DEAL to 511-511. Text DEAL to 511-511.
All pets are unique. Your pet's results can and will vary. Message and data rates may apply. Studies available upon request.
With you every day, we be grinding, and if you wanna come and text us,
if you love them enough to turn off your music and pretend like their music is your music.
Ah, this is mommy's jam.
Then surely you'll check nhtsa.gov/the right seat to make sure they're in the right car seat.
Let's play it again.
Check today at nhtsa.gov/the right seat. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ag Council.
Is Keeler on WIBX 950 online at WIBX950.com.
All right, so we're not getting Ryan Schmelz. If we get him,
well,
we'll get him.
Well, we may.
We might get him. We might not get him.
What the hell's going on today?
Anyway, talking with the people in London last night, I've been able to create a really cool relationship with the people over there. And so I'm on, I don't know, maybe once a month, once every other month, depending.
You're their guy.
For East Coast, stuff that goes on, stuff that happens.
Nice.
And it all stuck because my, you know, my daughter was going to school there and there was that. And then one day we got a phone call and then, you know, the rest goes on. Anyway, it is cool. And, they're also enamored over our politics right now. And they see us as here's how they look at us. They see us in a sad way that we have lost our way, mm-hmm. and at least this program sees Biden as old and slow, and Trump as corrupt and dangerous to democracy. That's how they see it.
Mm-hmm.
So, and they just see us as
the whole country or the
nation.
This program.
They see this program as just a problem. The whole nation they see as they, as much as, you know, it was us during versus the British, and they see us as this beacon of light and hope. Mm-hmm. I know that sounds overdramatic, but that's how they, at least the people that I speak to on this show, and they fear that we are so divided. This is not putting it on one. They do not. They're like, which part of the conversation last night was about the guy running named literally anybody else. And they just don't understand how a country of 300 million people cannot come up with a better candidate that could represent everybody that wasn't so old and wasn't so controversial, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Again, I'm just telling you how they see it. So it's very interesting. We don't talk a lot about that stuff, but this Baltimore thing was huge, and so is the abortion thing. And the abortion pill issue, which was before the Supreme Court yesterday. Let's see, what else can I talk about here? I've got so much, including very bad news.
Oh, gosh. There's been a lot of it.
Well, I'm here to give you the news that's very bad, and it's probably going to depress you a little bit. But I'm here to give it to you. I'm here to give it to you. There was a winner in Mega Millions.
I know. Gosh darn it.
A stinking piece of garbage from New Jersey purchased the winning ticket. And
probably
will,
Tommy DeVito's agent.
And will win $1.1 billion.
Which, the you know, and again, it's nothing to sneeze at, but the cash options, what, half that?
Yeah, I mean, they'll walk away with almost $600 million. I mean, they could immediately walk away and lend money to President Trump. Immediately. Although now that number has gone down. It's not as big as it was. That just is, well, and there's hope, though, because Powerball is still is now, I think, at 900 million, somewhere close to that.
I almost feel like it's going to hit now.
And also, I'm pretty sure the Comets 50-50 raffle comes to an end Friday night.
Oh, they're doing
or
their carryover?
This weekend. It's been the carryover.
Nice.
So if you're going to the game, you might want to get one of those tickets, because I think the number, I don't know where it is right now, but it's got to be high. Maybe we can find out from somebody. When I say high, it's probably over $30,000, $40,000, $50,000. Yeah.
Wow.
it's carryover for the whole month.
That'd be
and
nice.
Of course, it's heading into it's heading into this incredible time that will be happening with the Olympics coming to coming to Utica, the Olympic Games. What else? There was another stabbing and death in the subway in New York City.
Oh, this was also wasn't there a shoving?
Oh, this
incident?
Is the other. This is the other thing.
Somebody was shoved in front of the train again.
That's possible. This is the other thing that they see, that the country has just gone out of whack when it comes to bail reform and all these other things. Like, we're just allowing everything to happen and nobody goes to jail. Somebody assaults somebody, and then the next part is they were released on their own recognizance.
Well, and I
where are we going with that?
I know this has almost become a cliche as well, but the mental health, the dangerous mental health crisis of
that's a problem
of the world right now is something that I don't know that anybody really was trying to actively solve. I mean, there's a lot of talk about it, but what's going on to do about it? Because there is the element of bail reform. There's no question about it. But also, you've got a lot of mentally ill people.
Yeah. It's beyond that, and it's a combination of so many things. It's probably been going on for the last 20 years, building up to this time. You're right. The mental
the
health is a big
problem. The fact that somebody
would
just go up to a complete stranger, too.
And push him into
it's
the subway.
It's not like it's, I have a beef with you. I'm going to lure you down in the subway and kill you. No, it's just a random person.
Every time I look into that subway, I'm thinking, okay, what would I do? Well, I got to tell you, it's only like 3 or 4 inches, 5 inches from the train to the wall. So good luck there. If you get to the middle and get up on top of the ledge, you might be able to save yourself. But
you'd lose
chances
your legs.
Are you'll be electrocuted before you get up there. It's terrible.
Oh, yeah. I forgot about that.
Okay. This was a crazy swatting story out of Syracuse. Did you see?
These are awful.
911 call. A man at 4:50 p.m. yesterday told 911 operators that he'd shot his mother and killed her.
My gosh.
She was not breathing, and he would shoot anyone that entered the home. Turns out it was someone calling from another home and swatting. It was a scam. It was not even true. The people inside the home were completely unaware of why police were responding to their home. Here's the problem with that. When someone comes barging through your door, maybe you're taking a nap. You wake up. What's the first thing you're going to do? You're going to start swinging. You're going to grab your gun.
Right.
You're going to grab a baseball bat. Boom. You get shot. All because police think that something horrible is happening inside the house. In 2017, a police officer in Wichita, Kansas, shot and killed a man while responding to a hoax emergency call. And the same exactly what I said could happen is what happened there. Did I mention that somebody won the Mega Millions?
Yes, yes, and it wasn't us.
Just kills me. Well, it's nice that somebody.
So what does the jackpot go back down to? It's like, what, 10 5 million, 10
million? I think it's lower than that, to be honest.
$200,000?
$300.
Hobika is footing the bill for the Mega Millions.
So tonight, the Powerball is $865 million. And the Mega Millions goes to $20 million. Now, listen, you take
nothing
the 20.
Nothing to sneeze at.
You take the 20.
Yeah,
but,
you would.
Yeah. But what are you going to do? What else do I have here this morning that's interesting stuff?
How about the little girl in Syracuse, the 5-year-old that
terrible
they
story.
Found?
Yeah.
And it was as a result of her mother beating her with a belt.
I know.
And allegedly. And leaving her body.
Yeah.
As she showered, right?
And she said that she was in school, going to school in Georgia, living with other family members.
Yes. I find myself seeing those headlines and not. I realize it's a job where I'm supposed to, but I just can't read those stories.
So this
it drives me.
This lady is 29. Terrible. This lady is 29 years old. I've been following this since yesterday with the Syracuse, and she. This is one of 6 kids.
Yeah. Well, you're dealing again with that's got to be. I mean, it's terrible. You're either demonic or you're mentally ill
or on drugs. I hate
or
to say.
On drugs.
And
that's
the,
a good
and
point.
And the boyfriend is under investigation, and they're giving Onondaga County. He's giving them a hard time.
Well, we'll just let everybody out on their own recognizance, probably. An overweight alligator found living behind a former Coca-Cola plant was captured. Joe Beatrice actually captured it, I believe.
Dressed in his finest Coca-Cola regalia.
Is now on a the alligator's now on a diet to shed some of its 400 pounds. Here are some neighbors from where the gator used to live, and Croc Encounters director John Penner talking about the alligator's new diet. Here we go. Audio.
Eat them. Don't mess with them. You know, I don't even allow them over here.
I just hope nobody don't, you know, jump the fence or it don't come out and somebody get attacked.
That's a little heavy for that animal. The trapper caught the alligator and brought him over. It really isn't far away, probably 3-4 miles away. All of our alligators get a mix of pelleted diet. There's a diet made by Missouri. That's the Purina company that's made just for alligators and crocodiles. We feed a lot of that. We also feed fish. We also feed chicken. So we'll do that on a regular basis. And hopefully with time, he'll slender down a little bit.
I'm glad they can worry about things like that.
I'll tell you right now, my future in-laws just built a house in Florida, and we were there a couple weeks ago, and they have them right in the pond in the back of their house.
They are all over the place. A dog in Florida playing in the yard, this is also in Florida, playing in the yard, dug up an unexploded military weapon.
Oh, my gosh.
Matthew Sims is the homeowner talking about finding an old bomb. Your dog comes and jumps up on the bed and is carrying an old, unexploded bomb that he dug up in the backyard. Here's what the homeowner had to say about it.
Okay, is this live? You panic, and then you drop it. You couldn't really tell what it was until you...
Because that's the thing. What's the first thing a dog does? The first thing the dog does is comes, shows you what the dog has uncovered,
yes,
and drops it. Like, holy moly.
Okay, is this live? You panic, and then you drop it. You couldn't really tell what it was until you started to pull it up. And then once I got it, like, halfway out, I was like, oh, I know what this is. Let me just gently put this back down.
So, Bomb Squad had to come to the house, and they took care of it.
My gosh.
Da-da-da-da. Star Wars is, Disney's doing everything they can to make money on Star Wars. Their brand, Blue Milk. You're familiar with that? One of the later Star Wars is hitting stores April 17th as part of Lucasfilm's celebration of Star Wars Day on May the 4th. May the 4th
be with you.
Be with you. Luke drank blue milk in the original. I didn't realize this went back to 77. Luke drank blue milk in the original Star Wars in 1977. At Disney, if you go into their Star Wars section, they have like the bar. You know, with all the crazy aliens in the original movie.
Yeah.
They have the bar. You can go in. You can get the blue drink. You can get another drink. You can get alcoholic cocktails. And you can get non-alcoholic for the kids.
Is it blue? Is it just milk with food coloring? Or
is it some other type of drink? I have no idea.
Okay.
But anyway, that's going to hit stores. And people will buy it up and probably save it. Today is National Little Red Wagon Day. I have a story about this too. So, what was the hardware store that it's across from the train station that went out of business?
Doyle.
Doyle Hardware.
Doyle Hardware, yeah.
The Doyle Hardware building.
Doyle building, yeah.
So we, as they were closing, we got a tour of the Doyle Hardware building. And they took us onto one of the floors upstairs where stuff was stored. And there was a whole section with pallets. And they were all Little Red Wagon boxes from the 1960s. All unopened.
Unopened?
All unopened. There must have been
20
or 30 of them there.
The radio flyers?
The radio flyers.
Wow.
Yeah. That had never sold. And they were just sitting up there. I mean, you could have sold those. You could have had a...
Probably for a ton of money.
A Red Wagon Day, and come on out. We're selling... you know, that place was filled with... If you needed anything, I don't care what it was. You had an old house, and there was some old device in the house. You needed a part for it. If you needed anything, they had it. Really, really something. All right. Maybe one more. Not from here. I guess I'm out of stuff here. Coming up on the program today, next hour, we'll speak with Chief Scott Ingersoll on the Utica Fire Department's new facility that's planned for Oneida Square. This is going to be a brand-new building?
It is. It's going to be a facility that's really going to be advantageous for the ambulance, the EMT, and a lot of the firefighters there.
Legal expert Andrew Reed from Fox News Radio will go over three stories that we'll hit out there. And... He digs into those, which is pretty cool. Brandon Williams, congressman, is coming up, and we'll speak with him. He feels there's a lot to be learned from this this bridge collapse in Baltimore, and we'll speak with him about that coming up a little later on. Shelley Armato is the CEO of My Smart Pants, a women-owned business. What's she going to dig into on this bridge thing? She's got something about
Well, she's a certified women-owned business in the construction field.
Oh, in the construction field. And Ryan Nobles has been covering this story as well. He has a lot to talk about. First, though, news is next.
In our area, one new location is Tall Pines Insurance in Boonville. They're another independent insurance agency that takes pride in making customers happy that fits our culture at Gates Cole perfectly. Here's Greg Lee from the newest Gates Cole location, Tall Pines Insurance in Boonville.
The reason why I got into insurance was I wanted to allow my father the opportunity to retire and give back to my community. You know, we had the Boonville fire that wiped out a large area down here for us a few years ago, and so we showed up at the fire. You know, we were right there, ground zero with our insureds, made sure that they were taken care of quickly. You know, we were able to get people the money that they needed to cover their expenses from that loss.
For insurance for your home, auto, business, and just about everything else, trust your local independent insurance agency, Gates Cole Insurance, proudly representing Finger Lakes Fire and Casualty Company of Schumannsburg, New York.
The Potting Shed Antiques in Whitesboro is buying silver, gold, gold-filled, vintage costume, estate jewelry, and U.S. and Canadian coins. They've been your hometown buyer for the past 52 years. While other gold and silver buyers claim to offer the highest prices, the Potting Shed Antiques actually delivers. Let Don Hartman take a look at your individual pieces or your entire collection. The Potting Shed Antiques, open Thursdays, Fridays, and Saturdays. Please call ahead for an appointment. Visit thepottingshedsantique.com.
In the past five presidential election years, gold rose an average of 10%. This election year, where do you purchase gold for your portfolio? Don't believe the hype from the paid celebrities. Call me, America's gold expert, Dr. Mike Fulgence at Universal Coin and Bullion. I've advised attorney generals and the FTC on protections for you, the consumer. And I won't add ridiculous markups so you won't overpay for gold. Call Universal Coin and Bullion at 800-822-GOLD. That's 800-822-GOLD. 800-822-GOLD.
This Saturday, the Rome Capitol Theater presents It's a Mad World. Here's what people are saying about the movie.
I got physically sick from laughing.
You enjoyed the picture then?
Oh, yes, I'm going to see it again just as soon as I get out of the hospital.
Brace yourselves for Stanley Kramer's It's a Mad, 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 Mad World.
Saturday at the Rome Capitol Theater at 1:30 and 6:45. For more details, visit RomeCapital.com.
Prescriptions require an online consultation with a healthcare provider who will determine if appropriate. Restrictions apply. See website for details and important safety information. Subscription required. Price varies based on product and subscription plan.
Hey guys, did you know there's a generic form of Viagra that works just the same but is 95% cheaper? And you can get it online at hims.com/joy. Through Hims, you'll get a free medical consultation to determine the ED medication that's best for you. Discreet shipping if prescribed, a 100% online process, and a range of treatment options, including trusted generic alternatives to the name brands, at up to 95% off. ED is personal, and at Hims, so is treating it. Just go to hims.com/joy and get connected to a licensed medical provider online for free. With zero copay, no expensive appointments, and no awkward face-to-face conversations. To start your free online visit, you need to go to this exclusive address, hims.com/joy. That's hims.com/joy for your free online visit, hims.com/joy.
In the past five presidential election years, gold rose an average of 10%. This election year, where do you purchase gold for your portfolio? Don't believe the hype from the paid celebrities. Call me, America's gold expert, Dr. Mike Fulgence at Universal Coin and Bullion. I've advised attorney generals and the FTC on protections for you, the consumer. And I won't add ridiculous markups so you won't overpay for gold. Call Universal Coin and Bullion at 800-822-GOLD. That's 800-822-GOLD. 800-822-GOLD.
From the Stanley Theatre Studio, WIBX 950 Utica Rome, W295 DI Utica Rome, your news, talk, and sports leader, a Town Square media station.
It's a recovery mission now.
I'm Dave Anthony, Fox News. Six missing construction workers who were on the Key Bridge when it collapsed in Baltimore after a cargo ship collision are now presumed dead.
At this point, we do not know where they are, but we intend to give it our best effort to help these families find closure.
Maryland Secretary of State Police Roland Butler. Divers will be back in the river this morning dealing with
cold water, possible severe weather, and you have to imagine there are tons of twisted steel down in the water that they'll have to navigate through. It's sharp and very dangerous.
Fox's Connor Hansen's in Baltimore.
Now, this is also bound to create both travel issues locally and economic issues around the world. The port of Baltimore is the ninth busiest in the country with huge amounts of freight coming through.
The federal appeals court has just extended its hold on Texas's controversial border law, still blocking the state now from allowing police to arrest migrants across from Mexico illegally. The Supreme Court's considering a challenge to the FDA's approval of the abortion drug mifepristone. Justices at a hearing like Sonia Sotomayor appeared skeptical.
Even if there is some increase in emergency room visits, the question of when that rises to a sufficient safety risk is up to the FDA.
Another gag order for former President Trump. Less than 3 weeks before the start of his New York criminal trial, the judge barring him from talking about witnesses or prosecutors or court staff or their families. The Trump campaign says it's blocking his free speech. A Trump-Biden challenger as a running mate. Independent Robert F. Kennedy Jr.'s picked lawyer Nicole Shanahan.
Shanahan is still a registered Democrat, but says they are running as independents because the Democratic Party has lost its way.
I worry for the party's overwhelming interest in elitism, celebrity, and winning at all costs.
Democrats are worried that the third-party bid could possibly sink President Biden's re-election efforts.
Fox's Brooks Singman. America's listening to Fox News.
Don't let everyday aches and pains keep you from living your best life.
I don't think I really understood what people meant when they talked about pain until I started feeling it myself.
Start feeling better every day with Relief Factor, a daily supplement designed to support your body's fight against aches and pains.
Not only do I move better without pain, I just feel better.
Created by doctors, Relief Factor uses a unique formula of natural ingredients that target four metabolic pathways to address pain. Relief Factor doesn't just mask aches and pains, it helps reduce or even eliminate them.
Today, I do the things I love, and it doesn't occur to me to think about pain.
You can feel the difference all day, every day.
Join the over 1 million people who have tried Relief Factor's 3-week quick start kit. It's only $19.95. Visit relieffactor.com or call 1-800-4-RELIEF. That's 1-800, the number 4-RELIEF. And feel the difference of Relief Factor.
Trying to work out a strained relationship, Israel's Defense Minister Yoav Gallant was in Washington.
Over the past 6 months, we have been fighting a war against a brutal terror organization, Hamas, which is the ISIS of Gaza.
But the U.S. has had issues with Israel's planned offensive in Rafah, going after militants in an area of Gaza full of Palestinian civilians. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin says,
we need immediate increases in assistance to avert famine. And our work to open a temporary humanitarian corridor by sea will help, but the key is still expanding aid deliveries by land.
Israel canceled another delegation's trip to D.C., angry. The U.S. did not veto a U.N. resolution this week calling for a ceasefire but not condemning Hamas. Of course, relations are far more strained between the U.S. and China. Its leaders meeting with American business leaders there.
These are difficult days for diplomacy between China and the United States, but economic ties run deep. In a sign of their importance, President Xi Jinping's met representatives of some 20 firms in Beijing's Great Hall of the People. State media reports President Xi saying the history of China-U.S. relations is a history of friendly exchanges between our two peoples. China is trying to encourage foreign investment with its economy slowing, but U.S. companies are concerned about an anti-espionage law, exit bans, and raids on consultancies. Jonathan Savage, Fox News.
On Wall Street, stock futures are rising at more than 100 for the Dow the day after modest selling. Somebody got lucky last night in New Jersey. Really lucky. Winning a fortune. The Mega Millions jackpot that's been growing since December, more than $1.1 billion. It's the eighth largest lottery prize ever in the U.S. And if they choose the cash option, like most do, it'll be just over $537 million. I'm Dave Anthony. This is Fox News.
Good morning, WIBX 950 News Time, 7:05. I'm Andrew Domenico. 41 degrees with cloudy skies. Your full weather forecast is coming up. This update brought to you by the Stanley Center of the Arts, presenting Standards and Stories with Tony Danza, April 6th, 2024 at 7:30 p.m. Tickets are on sale now through Ticketmaster. That show is just around the corner. A 22-year-old woman from Herkimer County has pleaded guilty to murder. Herkimer County court officials say Taylor Goodhines of Mohawk entered a plea of guilty before Judge Crandall to one count of second-degree murder. Police say Goodhines stabbed another woman, identified as Takaya LaPlante, who was a mother of three, to death. Goodhines originally pleaded not guilty to second-degree murder and criminal possession of a weapon when she was arraigned in April of 2023. She remained in jail without bail until her next trial. Goodhines will be sentenced on May 20th. A Dutchess County man has died in a snowmobiling crash in the town of Webb. The Webb Police Department said Michael Volino of Millbrook was riding near the Adirondack Railroad tracks along Big Moose Road on Saturday around 7:47 p.m. when he lost control of his 2023 Skidoo snowmobile. The vehicle exited the roadway and crashed into a railroad crossing sign. Volino was pronounced dead at the scene. The crash remains under investigation. Utica police arrested a woman for allegedly slashing tires and damaging a vehicle. Police say the incident happened last month where a male victim's car was damaged enough to be assigned to the Criminal Investigations Division. Upon reviewing surveillance footage of the act, the victim recognized the suspect. That suspect, 19-year-old Justine Wells, turned herself in to authorities on Monday and was charged with third-degree criminal mischief. Starting today, a major change to New York State's move-over law will be going into effect. Drivers are now required to slow down and move over to avoid colliding with all vehicles that are stopped along a roadway, not just emergency vehicles. The goal is to prevent travelers, pedestrians, highway workers, and first responders from being injured. The law has been in place since 2010, and data shows that nationally nearly 300 people are struck and killed on the roadway each year. And Krispy Kreme donut lovers rejoice, even though there's no location in the upstate New York area. Krispy Kreme donuts will soon be sold at McDonald's locations across the country. We've got a story on our website.
That's a smart, probably a smart move for them.
We have a story on our website, WIBX950.com, that kind of gives you a little inkling of what the deal is, what donuts will be available. And we spoke to Joni Grandy at the local McDonald's Corporation here, and she'll likely join us tomorrow on First News with Keeler with a little bit more news on that. But it's looking like in the second quarter, we'll start to see Krispy Kreme donuts in area McDonald's. Krispy Kreme donuts at McDonald's will include original glazed, chocolate iced, cream-filled, and chocolate iced with sprinkles. The rollout will start later this year and will be available nationwide by the end of 2026. It is 7:08. Your weather forecast is according to Eyewitness News Chief Meteorologist Craig Flint, brought to you by the Destination Kia of Utica on Commercial Drive in Yorkville.
I'm Eyewitness News Chief Meteorologist Craig Flint in the WIBX Weather Center. Today, partly to mostly cloudy sky, milder, a few showers early, and then again later in the afternoon, a high near 60. Tonight, mostly cloudy, breezy with showers, a low of 37. And tomorrow, breezy, cooler, a few lingering showers early, then decreasing clouds, not as mild, a high near 50. For more on your local forecast, tune to Eyewitness News at 6 on WTR. I'm Meteorologist Craig Flint, WIBX 950 and 106.9 FM.
41 degrees under cloudy skies at 7:09. Sports brought to you by IBEW, NECA 43, local contractors. A busy week in Orlando is leading to more changes for the upcoming NFL season. Owners at the annual league meeting Tuesday approved proposals to push back the trade deadline and expand replay assistance. Teams are allowed to make deals 1 week later in the season, with the official deadline taking place on Tuesday after Week 9. Meanwhile, replay can now be used for intentional grounding. That was the other one I was struggling to come up with earlier.
Because they made some bad calls on that, and it would be nice to see the review of exactly where the quarterback was.
And
right?
I guess the big question is, with that being a replay possibility with the intentional grounding, roughing the passer, and out-of-bounds hit penalties.
Yeah,
all three
yeah.
will now be used with replay. Can a coach then challenge those penalties? That will be the question as well. Officials are only allowed to suggest a real-time reversal of a penalty and won't be allowed to initiate a formal review or suggest a flag be thrown. So maybe that answers that question. Changes to kickoffs and a ban on hip drop tackles have already been approved at the meetings, which wrap up on Wednesday. The Rangers have clinched a spot in the Stanley Cup playoffs as they lead the Metropolitan Division with 100 points at 48-20-4. They'll visit Colorado tomorrow night. The Islanders are hoping to put an end to their recent skid. They've dropped 7 of their last 8 games. They are 30-26-15, making it 6 points shy of the second wild card. They'll look to battle the Florida Panthers at Amerant Bank Arena in Sunrise tomorrow. The Knicks are seeking their 3rd win in a row as they are north of the border to take on the Toronto Raptors at Scotiabank Arena for tonight's game. And the start of the 2024 MLB regular season is right around the corner. Opening day is tomorrow. The Mets will begin the season at home when they host the Milwaukee Brewers. Veteran left-hander Jose Quintana is expected to get the start for the Mets. The Yankees are beginning the season on the road when they visit the Houston Astros. Cheaters. Lefty Nestor Cortez will toe the rubber for the Bronx Bombers, and Smitty informed me DJ LeMahieu is likely going to start the season on the DL, which is no bueno. WIBX 950 news time is 7:11.
You want industry standards met with affordable options and a crew who knows how important a sound roof is to you and your family. Dennis Spadula and Sons Roofing is your hometown roofers with deep roots in our community. Spadula Roofers specialize in residential roofing projects. They're a GAF certified master elite roofing contractor who keeps their standards above the rest. Call 315-733-1564 to find out more about their Roofs for Troops mail-in rebate. Dennis Spadula and Sons Roofing, your hometown roofers.
Hey, I got a question for you. You hate bending over to put on your shoes? Wish you should just put them on standing or sitting without ever having to touch them? If so, then I have the shoe for you. Introducing new hands-free Skechers Slip-ins. With new Skechers Slip-ins, you just step in and off you go. You don't even need to lace up. So how do Skechers Slip-ins work? Well, there's a special smooth comfort pillow in the heel that helps your foot slide right into place. So just step in them and go. Find new hands-free Skechers Slip-ins for the whole family at a Skechers store, Skechers.com, or wherever stylish footwear is sold.
The Women's World Championships are here. Utica brings 10 Olympic teams from around the world to the Adirondack Bank Center April 3rd to the 14th. The best hockey players in the world take over, and you don't want to miss it. Tickets are available for every game at EmpireStateTix.com. Enjoy world-class hockey. Support Team USA on their chase for a gold medal, and so much more. Live music, games, a Ferris wheel, and cultures from around the globe. Get your tickets at EmpireStateTix.com.
Get ready for this week's half-off Thursday deal with SeizeTheDeal.com. Score your half-off gift certificate to Edible Arrangements tomorrow morning starting at 8. Get $50 for $25 with Seize the Deal's half-off Thursday. Edible Arrangements has gifts for all occasions. Birthdays, anniversaries, no matter what the occasion, Edible Arrangements has you covered. Don't forget their delicious smoothies and dip fruit. Two great locations, Black River Boulevard in Rome and in the Orchard in New Hartford. Get your half-off Thursday gift certificates tomorrow from Edible Arrangements at SeizeTheDeal.com.
Hi, this is Bill Cole from Gates Cole Insurance with exciting news. We are expanding with a couple of new offices in our area. One new location is North Country Estates Insurance in Lowellville. They are another independent insurance agency that takes pride in making customers happy and fits our culture at Gates Cole perfectly. Here is William Schaub from the newest Gates Cole agency, North Country Estates Insurance in Lowellville.
Working with us as an independent agent with this many companies, we will often call our clients and say, we're going to reduce your premium if you like. We have the companies that do well in New York and specifically this area. The coverages that we provide are commercial and personal insurance. That's the home, the auto, ATV, motorcycle. There's nothing more fun than taking care of a customer and being able to tell them that we're able to save them some money.
Proudly representing Finger Lakes Fire and Casualty Company of Trumansburg, New York. Gates Cole Insurance. We'll take care of you.
Introducing Tanzite Stone Tile Flooring. a game changer in the tile industry. Say goodbye to the trade-off between durability and easy installation with Tanzite's revolutionary indoor-outdoor stone tile. Visit Tanzite.com to see how our tile is installed without concrete or mortar. Instead, our innovative rubber gasket system connects the tiles together. Each tile coming pre-assembled, you simply grab one and place it. No expertise needed. At Tanzite.com, you can see how our foam-backed tiles contour to cover any existing floor while insulating against sound and cold. Beautiful and versatile, Tanzite tile adapts to indoor or outdoor use, from kitchens to patios, on concrete basements or wooden decks, all with the durability of stone that's guaranteed for life. Witness this innovative product yourself and order a sample today at Tanzite.com. That's TANZITE.com.
950 and 106.9 FM. This is Keeler.
All right, some comments that I can get into here if
you'd
like.
Oh, my gosh.
There's
how did
a ton
I forget?
Of them. There are...
One of them, Lance and Lee.
I don't know. I'm not looking in that section right there. I have Richard. Richard, I can't read that. Come on. You know I can't read that. Where do you live? 50s next week? I see low to mid 40s and rain. I looked on my phone this morning. It looked like 50s next week, but you are one day next week. It'll be 50, but you're correct. It mainly will be mid 40s next week. And then 50s, but that's too far out. I think they take their averages when they give that 10-day forecast. But it's going to be colder. I mean, today we'll get almost 60 degrees, and then it's going to get colder. We've lost a lot of snow, though.
Yeah, and especially if you're prone to, well, not flooding, because I don't think it's to that extent. I think the melting has gone gradually. But you do have a soppy yard if you've got some of those low-lying areas.
You do, yeah. Any others you want to get to here?
Well, I'm trying to figure out how to
open
them.
Let's move on. Let me go to Utica Fire Chief Scott Ingersoll, who is on the line right now. Good morning.
Good morning.
So this is good news with a new facility coming. First new facility in how long?
So, yeah, we haven't built a new fire station since 1976.
Wow.
Yeah, and obviously we're still using two stations, one that was opened in 1906.
Wow.
For horses, and then on Shepherd Place that was opened in 1914. That was the first station built for motorized fire equipment. So,
wow.
Yeah.
So yeah, I wonder who was mayor. Was it Palinga at that time?
In the mid-70s, it could have been Hannah.
At what point did he become the enemy of the fire department, or the fire department become the enemy of him? I guess that must have been the 90s.
Yeah. Well, I think there were some of those issues back in the 70s, but I obviously I wasn't around then. So,
yeah, lucky
I'm
you.
Not super familiar.
Lucky you. Okay, so I can only imagine, based on what we've seen with the hospital, how you can build something properly for proper flow, for emergency calls, et cetera, et cetera. What does it mean for a new firehouse?
So this process is just the first step of it's just the first initial step to start the planning stages and design stages, go find architects, engineers, and also retain more grant writers to go after more federal and state funding so we can actually build the station now. This is just really a huge first step for us due to the support of the, Senator Schumer and Gillibrand. Yeah. And obviously, we got to go to the community. We need to get together with the administration and start pushing this project forward. There's a lot of things that we have to do next. We're trying to model this similar to a project that they just completed in the city of Saratoga Springs, where they were able to secure a lot of federal funding to cover cost of about 70 to 75% of their facility, of their brand new fire station that they built. So we're trying to jump on that bandwagon as well and model our program after that. And and to really push forward with this. This is obviously going to be a 3 to 5 year project before we open the doors. You know, I'm hoping it's closer to three, but with everything recently, everything takes longer than expected.
Yep. Now, this is going to be constructed in the area of Oneida Square. I believe you already have an existing fire station there. What will that mean? Are you going to take other properties in that area, do you feel? Or is it you have enough room in the footprint of the existing station now to maybe tear down and rebuild?
So that's really one of the things that this initial funding will help us to identify. There are a couple parcels in that immediate area that we would really like to look at. I don't want to get too far away from our existing location. The problem that we run into is that station last year did over 12,000 calls for service.
Wow.
And it's tough to for any project to knock that station down and rebuild it while simultaneously deploying those resources
right.
to other parts of the city. That's going to be really difficult. It's going to be a pretty heavy lift. So, it's really something that we got to look at and dig into more. And once we get that figured out, we will, start looking at the plans and sizes and everything.
All right. Very interesting and good news for the city of Utica. Good news for the fire department.
Yeah, definitely.
Who gets to stay there though? Because you're gonna any firefighter is gonna want to be in the
the brand new
building.
Yeah, we'll see. We'll see how many guys want to see.
Okay? All right.
Now, Chief, while we have you, I just want to ask your thoughts and feel free if you're not able to answer or talk about this. Your thoughts about the potential hiring of a public safety commissioner. I know in conversations we've had with Mayor Galimi that he has the full faith of you and Chief Williams in the police department. But do you feel the city needs a public safety commissioner, and would you be supportive of that?
Yeah, I support that office, this establishing a public safety commissioner. I think that that provides us with a layer of somebody to go to instead of going to the mayor with certain questions all the time. I think that would help facilitate some of the things that we do with our department. I view the public safety commissioner role as something that somebody that facilitates between multiple agencies, not just the police and fire department, but with codes and social services and other things, and helps with some emergency management style operations as well. That's something that we've been behind the ball on a little bit.
Yeah,
and you'd prefer it not to be Mayor Galimi, correct?
No, not saying that at all. We've spoken multiple times about the public safety commissioner, and I think he has a good idea of what a good vision of what he wants the public safety commissioner to accomplish.
He does seem like he wants it to be another person.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A couple things. Thank you, Donna. It was Edward Hanna who was mayor when the last fire station was built. Isn't that ironic? I feel anyway, based on where it all ended for him. And then Mike says, the firefighter said, working out of this fire station, it seems like we're dealing with a majority of overdoses that are taking place in the city. It seems like it's never ending. This is a real new problem that firefighters are having to deal with.
It's absolutely correct. I know over the last, I believe it was Monday, we had somewhere around the area of 6 overdoses within a 24-hour period. I stopped at an overdose last week. Watched the guys administer three different rounds of Narcan before the person was able to start breathing on their own. So this is a pretty common occurrence. We actually, last year in 2023, we utilized well over 400 doses of Narcan in the community. And so that's a consistent problem.
Yeah.
It's unfortunately, it's something that we deal with on a daily basis.
A couple of other questions from the WIBX 950 app.
Yes, this is John from Bridgewater, Chief, asking how renovations to Engine House 1 on Whitesboro Street are coming.
So that project is coming along great. We are hoping to have that apparatus back at that station in the beginning of June. Due to the amount of work that had to be done there, we had to relocate them to the South Utica Fire Station temporarily. And obviously that's not ideal for our response times to West Utica and to other parts of the city, but it's one thing I learned from doing a renovation project down here at the Central Fire Station is that it's really difficult to coexist in a building and have a lot of renovations done at the same time.
Yeah,
so,
not easy. Yep.
Yeah. So that project's coming along great. I'm very impressed with the workmanship, and they actually set the new staircase going to the second floor yesterday. So we actually have stairs that we don't have to worry about falling in on.
That's and, good. Yeah.
So it's a big milestone, and that station's going to look fantastic when it's done.
All right, Chief Ingersoll, we appreciate your time. Thank you. Congratulations on the new facility. A lot of things seem to be going on in a moving in a good direction.
Yeah, I appreciate it, guys. Thank you.
All right, thank you so much. Chief Ingersoll with the Utica Fire Department. Comments this morning off the app. When are you guys back in the regular studio, Jordan in Whitesboro? It should be next week, although we're also going to be doing some broadcasting from the women's championship down at the auditorium. So we will probably be back out on the road. We're nomads here. Probably back out on the road before you know it, believe it or not.
We're drifters.
Fred and Clinton from last hour, the Thruway Bridge collapse was April 5th, 1987. Yeah, that sounds to be about right. Convinced my husband to call Revive after listening to you, Andrew. His appointment is Friday.
Nice.
Took a while to get in. Very, very hopeful, Darlene and Sequoit. Darlene, also, my grandsons are 7 and 9. They love Popeye cartoons. And is there anything I missed? I think I got everything in there for the most part. And there's one more on that bridge collapse. Mike, while I know virtually nothing about nautical things, it feels like they should have tugs taking care of these large ships until they clear bridges.
That's what Ed Welsh said.
And get to open water. I think you're absolutely correct. Really, really doesn't make any sense. All right, 727. Coming up, three legal topics with Andrew Reed from Fox News Radio. Then Hobika's free money question of the day. And Davey this morning, we're looking at how much money today?
$200.
$200. Again. $200. As we round out the month of March, we'll have that free money question coming up in a few minutes from Hobika and WIBX.
Bet Steep Pawnee Chevrolet in Herkimer, because it's truck season. They've got over 50 Silverados in stock and more on the way. Get behind the wheel of a brand new 2024 Silverado 1500 Crew Cab LT 4x4. Lease it for 3 years at 10,000 miles per year for just $498 a month. Or purchase with interest rates as low as 1.9% and get $5,250 in rebates. Need a heavy-duty truck? They've got a huge selection of 3/4 and 1-ton trucks for work or play. They have the truck that fits your needs. Together, let's drive. Stop in and see why it's always easy to do business at Steep Pawnee Chevrolet, Route 28 in Herkimer, or online at steeppawneechevy.com.
For lease and financing offers, customers must qualify for top-tier credit through GM Financial. Offer on select models must have a 2010 or newer trade-in and a current lease and household for lease offer. All taxes, fees, and first payment due on delivery. See salesperson for details. Must take delivery by March 31st, 2024.
Some stores will tell you they carry Purple Mattress, but they may only have two or three on the floor. Only Mattress Express has 9 different purples on the floor. Stop into any Mattress Express store, try all the purples, and then we'll pull up the website and give you the same price as online.
As you get a bit older, you start to think about things. Like, if we get sick, we're at higher risk. But we're absolutely not going to stop living our lives. And what helps us do that? Getting our flu shot, the updated COVID vaccine. Yeah, we stay on top of these things so that we can do the things that we love with the people we love, because we don't want to miss out.
A message from the New York State Department of Health.
This Saturday, the Rome Capitol Theater presents It's a Mad World. Here's what people are saying about the movie.
I got physically sick from laughing.
You enjoyed the picture then?
Oh, yes, I'm going to see it again just as soon as I get out of the hospital.
Brace yourselves for Stanley Kramer's It's a Mad World.
Saturday at the Rome Capitol Theater at 1:30 and 6:45. For more details, visit RomeCapital.com.
When you don't have enough to eat, all you think about is food. That makes it hard to give your best.
Nearly impossible to feel your best.
And it makes tough decisions even tougher.
At Food Bank of Central New York, all we think about is food too, and how to get it to the people who need it most. Think you can help? Give today at foodbankcny.org.
If you're looking for flooring, boy, do I have the perfect place for you. This is Bill Keeler, and I highly recommend In Sarah's Flooring Outlet, the area's leading flooring store. They have the absolute largest inventory in Central New York, and it's a brand new store at the Route 49 Plaza in Marcy. And if you're looking for Pergo Extreme, they have a price guarantee anywhere in the area within a 60-mile radius of their store. It's a pretty awesome deal, and you know you're going to get the best deal at Inseras. Log on to their website at InserasFlooringOutlet.com and sign up to save $50 off your next purchase of $500 or more. You can shop online or in the store. You will not find a better selection than Inseras Flooring Outlet. See why more people buy from the big store. It's selection, it's price, and it's a 6-month interest-free financing. Log on to the website, InserasFlooringOutlet.com, and see for yourself or visit their store. Inseras Flooring Outlet, Route 49 Plaza, River Road in Marcy.
A flex head bed is where each head goes up and down independently, but it's still one solid mattress, and Mattress Express has the largest selection in New York State. Right now, get a queen flex head bed with adjustable base and sheets for only $14.99. Locations at MattressExpressNY.com.
In the past 5 presidential election years, gold rose an average of 10%. This election year, where do you purchase gold for your portfolio? Don't believe the hype from the paid celebrities. Call me, America's gold expert, Dr. Mike Fulgence at Universal Coin and Bullion. I've advised attorney generals and the FTC on protections for you, the consumer. And I won't add ridiculous markups, so you won't overpay for gold. Call Universal Coin and Bullion at 800-822-GOLD. That's 800-822-GOLD. 800-822-GOLD.
Is Keeler on WIBX 950. Online at WIBX950.com.
All right, back here coming up, we'll do Hobika's free money question of the day. Chance for you to win $200 here this morning. And right now, though, we have Andrew Reed, attorney, who through Fox News Radio helps us with some topics that are out there right now. Andrew Reed, good morning.
Good morning. Glad to be back.
Glad to have you back. Thanks so much. 3 topics I throw at you, and we'll see what we get in terms of your take on these stories. There is a dog food fight at the U.S. Supreme Court. What is the story?
This one has some unique twists and turns. So this is a case where a dog food brand was sued over their medicated dog food when some users found out it really didn't have any medication in it. But the reason is going up to the Supreme Court is that there's a question here. They tried to certify this as a class action. It got moved to federal court and then got put back into state court. So the question is it right for it to be in state court or federal court? And there's a lot of nuanced issues there. There's a lot of things people are looking at and doing with this case. But ultimately, this case is up on appeal to the Supreme Court. It's one right now they're still waiting to see if the Supreme Court is actually going to review it. So this one is more of a wait and see, but it does have some unique storylines to it for sure.
Okay, very interesting. Topic number 2, U.S. lawsuit against Apple could make the iPhone experience, more consumer-friendly. What's going on here?
There is a lot with this case. And essentially what the Department of Justice is trying to do here is just say Apple has too much monopoly over the cell phone industry. They say they just have so much market share. They have so much control. And by the way they present some of their contracts and some of their user agreements that it limits the ability of a user or other companies to utilize the Apple products and ecosystem. So it's one, there's a lot of nuances. This, I will say, the complaint is very lengthy. So there's just a lot said. This also falls after Apple was taken to court over in the EU, and they've had to make some changes. Like the latest iPhones now use USB-C. That was because of a mandate over in Europe. So yeah, a lot of this is actually stuff that may get taken care of because Apple's already taking certain steps over in Europe.
Well, you know, Apple like to have their own little, you had to buy their own cords and their own chargers and their own this, that, and the other thing. And that move out in that happened in Europe forced them to go with the Type-C USB, which is standard around the world. And that's good for us because we can now buy a much less expensive cord for our phone to charge it. One little example there, right?
Very, very much a good example. And it's one, there's so many different plays. There's people that say, oh, they like it because it is kind of a closed system. They know everything's going to work. But there are some flip sides to that if it makes it difficult for companies to compete. Yeah. So,
yep. And one more, a third topic, law students sued against Chicago Bears. And he's suing the Bears because they didn't hire him as their legal diversity fellow. And he says they didn't hire him because he is white. What do you think about this one?
This one is going to be interesting to see if it actually goes anywhere, if it settles very quickly. This case was just recently filed, so the Chicago Bears have not responded yet, so we don't have their side of the story. But at least from the way the complaint reads and the reports state, this one has a lot of nuances to it because this gentleman did put in his resume, and one of the unique things that came up and was noted in one of the reports was that he can show and has as an exhibit to the complaint that someone from the Chicago Bears actually looked at his LinkedIn profile, which has his picture, so they could confirm certain details about him, and then he received a rejection shortly thereafter. So it's one, there's some nuances and some issues here that could be interesting, especially when we have the recent case by the Supreme Court regarding college admissions and
how
you can take into all these characteristics and in some cases can't take those characteristics into account when doing college admission. That's also had some ramifications in the HR world. So that's where some people are watching this to see if it actually does move forward to kind of bring into play some of these questions and maybe resolve some potential issues around that Supreme Court case.
All right. Interesting. We'll see where all of these go. And as always, Andrew Reed, thank you. Interesting stuff. We appreciate it.
You're welcome. Glad to be on.
Have a great day.
You too.
Andrew Reed from Fox News Radio.
Excellent mind.
Great legal mind that goes after all these topics. That Chicago Bears thing is going to be quite interesting, right?
Yeah. I'd be interested to follow that one and see what happens.
Yeah. All right, let's do Hobika's free money question of the day. And, Davey, this morning we're looking for, by the way, $200 on the line. And we're looking for...
Caller 4.
Fourth caller right now at 315-736. Oops. 315-723-3824.
We'll be back there soon.
We'll be back in the studio soon. But for now, the number is 315-723-3824. That number again, 315-723-3824. You can see it up on our YouTube feed. Just search Keeler Live Stream, and it's a line that comes right into us here in Studio B, which we're nearing the end. It'll be at some point probably next week where we'll end up in the brand-new digs, the new studio. We'll do Hobika's free money question coming up next to WIBX.
Nationally recognized programs for heart and stroke care, sophisticated and innovative treatments and intervention by renowned medical experts, all while providing education in the community to prevent disease. The Wynn Hospital, inspiring better health with a commitment to our community. This is for you.
At MVHS, our team members fell in love with care long ago. Their lives were changed, and their world has been expanding ever since. In respect, compassion, knowledge, and ability. And it's only just begun. Because fueling the future of care starts here at the Wynn Hospital. Local care on a whole new level. The Wynn Hospital. Unwavering commitment and compassion. Learn more at mvhealthsystem.org. This is for you.
Hi, this is Tom Cole from Gates Cole Insurance with exciting news. We're expanding with a couple of new offices in our area. One new location is Tall Pines Insurance in Boonville. They're another independent insurance agency that takes pride in making customers happy. That fits our culture at Gates Cole perfectly. Here's Greg Lee from the newest Gates Cole location, Tall Pines Insurance in Boonville.
The reason why I got into insurance was I wanted to allow my father the opportunity to retire and give back to my community. You know, we had the Boonville fire that wiped out a large area down here for us a few years ago, and so we showed up at the fire. You know, we were right there, ground zero with our insureds, made sure that they were taken care of quickly. You know, we were able to get people the money that they needed to cover their expenses from that loss.
For insurance for your home, auto, business, and just about everything else, trust your local independent insurance agency, Gates Cole Insurance, proudly representing Finger Lakes Fire and Casualty Company of Trumansburg, New York.
Hey, everybody in upstate New York. I don't know where in upstate New York, but thanks for listening to the Keeler Show. Never met this man. Don't know why I'm telling everybody to listen, but thank you very much. By the way, this is Larry David from Curb Your Enthusiasm. I have nothing else really to say to you, but I thank you for listening to me tell you to listen to this man, Bill Keeler on WIBX.
Now back to Keeler.
Do you know how many people died so you could have the right to vote?
You gotta vote. Haven't you seen the Rock the Vote stuff or Pop Daddy's Vote or Die?
All anyone's talking about is this election. It's ruining Twitter.
WIBX 950 and 106.9 FM. The Keeler Show.
Da 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 da. What did you expect Ingersoll to say? This is Lance and Lee. What did you expect Ingersoll to say about having a public safety commissioner? As a supervisor of the department that has the top payroll in the city, he has to say what Gallimi wants.
He's a brick house.
Just like he did when Paul Mary was mayor, when he said the city didn't need a commissioner.
Well,
he's in a position where he has to defend his mayor. And that's that. That's just the way
Well, and here's the thing. I mean, The reality is Gallimi has said repeatedly it shouldn't be the mayor and it should be somebody else in the position
should be
in place.
Yeah. All right, the Falcon Clinic in Washington Mills accepting new patients right now as we speak. If you need a new family doctor or take an osteopathic approach, you're having pain, you're having issues, you just don't feel it right, your body informs you. You must listen and get to see a doctor. My dad went through a really rough year last year. And now Dr. Chmielewski is his family practitioner. His doctor retired, and this was perfect for him. And Dr. Chmielewski was very helpful with getting my father back on his feet. The Falcon Clinic. Call today. They're accepting new patients. 315-507-4751. The Falcon Clinic in Washington Mills. On the line right now, ready to take a shot at Hobika. Joseph and Andrew Hobika's free money question of the day is... Is it Aiden in Sequoia, Davey?
Yes.
Hello, Aiden. Good morning.
Hello, Aiden.
Good morning.
You ready to go?
Yeah.
All right. You know how this works. You're going to have exactly 7 seconds to answer our question.
Okay.
And if you get the answer in, you win $200. Okay, here is your question. Within 10... How many Kmart stores are left in the United States? Ready, go.
14?
You're going to go with 14. Is that your answer? 14?
Yeah.
The correct answer, Aiden, the correct answer is 6.
Yeah!
So within 10, you are correct. You won $200. You won, Aiden. Congratulations, man.
Thank you.
How about that?
I told Congressman Williams we were going to try and give money away today, and
50,
that we
100,
did.
100, 150, $200. All right, Aiden. Nice guess, man. That was really good.
Thank you.
Yeah. All right, stand by. I'm going to give you to Davey. He's going to hook you up, okay?
Okay, thank you.
All right, thanks, man. Have a great day, and congratulations. Big winner right there. $200. Aiden in, I don't know where he's from.
Sequoit.
Sequoit.
Aiden in Sequoit.
All right, cool. All right, can I just keep flying here?
Keep it rolling.
We were, I want to play this audio one more time of the Baltimore tragedy, which could have been so much worse. And it took an amazing crew that realized that this barge was actually going out of control. They immediately they stopped traffic going on to the Key Bridge in Baltimore. And if it wasn't for this call that went out, hundreds of people would have died. Listen to this. This is actually fast communication from emergency workers.
We advise the entire Key Bridge in the harbor. I advise to hold all traffic from coming to the bridge. I advise again, the entire Key Bridge has fallen into the harbor.
That was the last call that went in, but this was the call that stopped cars from getting onto the bridge.
Any one of you guys on the south side, one of you guys on the north side, hold all traffic on the Key Bridge. There's a ship approaching that just lost their steering. So that until you get that under control, we got to stop all traffic.
Army route to the south side.
Yeah, if we can stop traffic, just make sure no one's on the bridge right now. There's a crew up there. You might want to notify whoever the foreman is, see if we can get them off the bridge temporarily.
10-4, once the other unit gets here, I'll ride up on the bridge.
213 dispatch, the whole bridge just fell down. Everybody, the whole bridge just collapsed.
Do we know if all traffic will stop?
I can't get to the other side, sir. The bridge is down.
C-13, I'm holding all traffic northbound.
They held traffic, and it saved lives. It amazingly saved lives. That one dispatcher, you heard him say, I'll drive up onto the bridge as soon as the other unit gets here. Hope he didn't do that.
I know.
Because he would have gone in. Just crazy. On the line right now, Congressman Brandon Williams. Congressman, good morning.
Good morning, Bill. Good morning.
So there are so many different ways to look at this, I would think. Number one, how in the world does this happen? Why aren't they using a tug to take that boat out safely, that big cargo ship or whatever it was, cargo barge? But then on top of it, how vulnerable are we in our cities around the country?
Well, you know, because I've got 500 days at sea on a submarine does not maneuver very well on the surface. It actually is considered a deep draft vessel because you only see a small part of it. And we have, like this container ship, we have, one propeller and one rudder. And that makes it very difficult to maneuver in a tight space. And so we always had tugs with us. Now, obviously, our mission, everything about our boat is different. But but I was surprised, too, that they didn't have tugs alongside to make sure they got out of the harbor and got out of that bridge, under that bridge.
Yeah,
successfully.
Yeah.
That surprised me.
And then the second part of this is I never really thought that a boat hitting one of the pillars or
support
suspension
columns.
That one of them would take out an entire bridge.
Yeah, the engineering of these things is that, they're engineered to withstand, certain loads, number of cars going across, particularly wind and those kinds of forces. And, the thing about an engineer is you always say, well, any fool could build a bridge, but how do you build one with the least cost, the least amount of materials, that kind of thing? And so, that's what they design. That's true for all bridges. And if you take away a key support, that the engineering no longer would hold it up.
So we like to legislate things in this country. It's there's a problem, and we like to legislate. Is there any legislation that we could take out of this? Is there any anything we could take from this to create new rules, apply this to other cities around the country? What's your take on all of it?
Yeah, let me give you two examples. Remember with the Exxon Valdez spilled all of the oil in Alaska, and there was a couple of things that we did. One is you had to have a double hull vessel, you know, in other words, the oil sat in one container and then it was separated from the hull of the ship. So we changed the rules in that case. This is a long time ago. And another rule was that you had to have a tugboat when you had hazardous materials like chemicals or oil or that kind of thing in any of these sensitive areas for exactly this kind of reason. So, you know, those are examples of what have worked in the past and could work in this place. There's also, you know, protection around these support pillars. And you see in a lot of other bridge designs, you know, elsewhere, particularly in the San Francisco Bay, you know, they have these bumpers, if you will, you know, big rock piles that prevent exactly this kind of accident from happening, so that the bow of the ship would hit, you know, would hit these rocks and push it aside rather than let it just continue and take out the pillar like it saw. So that's going to run through my committee, the Transportation and Infrastructure Committee, and I know we're going to be having hearings on this. So.
Very interesting. And boy, we're really lucky, too, that this came at a very active bridge with a port. So it meant that there was construction going on there at the same time. So you had people, dispatchers, who were there as part of their job was keeping track of the bridge and traffic through the waterways. So, you know, imagine, you know, we're going back to 1987 when New York State Thruway Bridge collapsed. No one was monitoring that, even though there were high waters and flooding going on. The fact that there was a dispatch there and the fact that they were able to, the audio clip I played just before you came on, they were able to reach out and stop traffic from going on that bridge. That's just incredible.
You know, then this is just standard practice. You know, that a bridge that goes over a port would be manned all the time.
Yeah.
And they would be monitoring Channel 16, the Marine Emergency Channel, and the General Hailing Channel for Marines called Channel 16. And I'm surprised we haven't heard the Channel 16 call, you know, VHF radio saying, you know, Mayday, 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 this is... you know, MV Dolly, we have lost propulsion, we are located here, and we are, you know, heading towards the key bridge. Unable to, you know, to maneuver.
Yeah. And that
tells all the other ships to stay away. Sorry, but the bridge would be monitoring that. Sorry.
So, yes, the bridge monitored that, and the call that we heard going out then was they knew that the barge had lost steering, and it was headed towards the bridge, so that's when they cleared traffic. But we have not heard the actual audio from the cargo ship itself. Andrew.
No, Congressman.
No, I haven't.
No.
I'm surprised. I mean, yeah, go ahead. Sorry.
No, it's okay. I was just saying, I mean, you can see in the video lights and power to the ship went out two or three times prior to it striking that pillar. I mean, could that have anything to do with why they weren't able to communicate?
That's a very good question. This is a real mystery to me. So this ship, it's a very large container ship. It has a single propulsion motor, a giant diesel motor. You know, think of like a locomotive engine on a train, except it's tied to a shaft and a big propeller. And that's it, right? So single screw, so that's a maneuverability thing. And then it's got a rudder, you know, sitting back behind that. And then the electric power generation, my understanding is that it has, a couple of electric generators that are separate from the propulsion. And it would be a diesel generator. But a typical configuration would be that they would have separate fuel filters, maybe a common, fuel source, but it would go through a fuel filter before it got to those engines. The fact that they say they lost propulsion and then they lost electric power, that doesn't make sense to me. from a systems design. And I know that they're going to look very closely into how that happened, but typically they would have some redundancy there.
You're not suggesting that this was nefarious in any way, are you?
I'm not actually suggesting it's nefarious. I'm suggesting that it is...
maybe negligent?
I don't want to say suspicious as in it's a crime. It's suspicious into how they were operating the ship in a way that you could lose propulsion and lose power at the same time. That should not really happen. Those are separate systems.
So,
to have a multi-system failure at the same time is really suspect.
Well, it could turn out to be criminally negligent.
Yeah, there could be some serious negligence.
Not following
here.
Safety procedures, et cetera, et cetera.
Yeah. Checklists. I mean,
and who investigates? Is it NTSB or Coast Guard? Who does the investigation?
Well, the Coast Guard for sure and the NTSB.
Okay.
Both of those. The FBI is going to be all over it.
Yeah.
So that ship is crawling with people, and they're interviewing everybody for sure.
Wow. Yeah, it shows. And then at the end of the day, we cannot ignore that it shows how each one of these ports, these major bridges, are vulnerable to something that might be nefarious.
Well, we rely on our infrastructure, you know, and that's true for water. It's true for electricity. It's true for you know, our roads, as you suggest, and we take it for granted every day. We just assume that it's all going to be there. But there are parts of our infrastructure that are particularly important. You know, I'm always concerned about our electric grid and where they, you know, our grid meets and, you know, the big transformers that, you know, that provide power and distribute power. And that's very sensitive infrastructure. If that goes out, it's very hard to replace. But, you know, take a look around. I've made a priority for our infrastructure. A lot of infrastructure you can't see, you know, water and sewer and all of these things that are under the ground that we just take for granted. But there is a lot of this infrastructure that's totally that is vulnerable. And it's also critical for us. So,
and it's especially in on the east coast, especially in the Northeast, very, very old in many cases.
It is. We're, you know, I know that we see projects that we're trying to get support and funding for, you know, where the sewage pipes are 100 years old are crumbling. And that's obviously bad for our environment and bad for our communities. So anyway, we're seeing this all the time, and we've underinvested in infrastructure here in Central New York. And that's something, that we're trying to remedy.
All right. Interesting stuff. Congressman, thank you for your input and the experience that you have, of course, in the military lends to all of this. We appreciate it.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
All right. Have a great day, Congressman Brandon Williams. And, you do kind of wonder. I have a feeling when this is all said and done, we're going to find out that certain protocols that are mandated were not followed.
Yeah, or there was a laundry list of things that weren't checked off.
Yeah, well, which would fall into that category. Yeah. So, yeah, it'll be very, very interesting. Fastest growing real estate company in the area is River Hills Properties. Oh, I got a break. We'll tell you more about that coming up. Sorry.
You want industry standards met with affordable options and a crew who knows how important a sound roof is to you and your family. That is Spadula & Sons Roofing is your hometown roofers with deep roots in our community. Spadula Roofers specialize in residential roofing projects. They're a GAF certified master elite roofing contractor who keeps their standards above the rest. Call 315-733-1564 to find out more about their Roofs for Troops mail-in rebate. That is Spadula & Sons Roofing, your hometown roofers.
Are you ready to smell better naked? I'm Dr. Shannon Klingman, the OBGYN creator of Lumi, the whole body deodorant that's clinically proven to control odor for 72 hours on pits, feet, privates, and beyond. It's pH optimized to safely and effectively control odor anywhere you have it, but wish you didn't. Plus, it's proven to work better than a shower with soap alone. Whether you shower twice a day or three times a week, Lumi works better. And who doesn't want zero body odor? With over 200,000 five-star reviews, I'm so sure you're going to love it, or you can return it for free.
There's a special offer for listeners. Use code 800 and get an extra $5 off a Lumi starter pack that comes with a solid stick, cream tube, free product of your choice, and ships free with code 800. LUMEdeodorant.com. Code 800 for an extra $5 off a Lumi starter pack. Love it or return it for free. That's LUMEdeodorant.com. Code 800.
Divers keep searching a river in Baltimore. I'm Dave Anthony, Fox News, but it is not a search for bridge collapse survivors.
At this point, we do not believe that we're going to find any of these individuals still alive.
So Coast Guard Rear Admiral Shannon Gilreth says it's a recovery mission now for six construction workers who were on the Key Bridge when a cargo ship collision brought it crashing down. Why is still a big question. National Transportation Safety Board Chair Jennifer Homendy just told Fox.
We've seen the reports about power issues. We do need to verify that. We do have the voyage data recorder right now.
Fox's Griff Jenkins reports from Baltimore. This is also a big deal this morning.
The voice transmission with the dispatch of the Maryland Transportation Authorities after that Mayday call went out. They're hailing those individuals as heroes because they stopped the traffic and saved countless lives on this bridge by stopping cars from coming on to it at 1:30 in the morning.
While the U.S. and Israeli relations are strained over the war in Gaza, Israel's dealing now with militants at its northern border.
Hezbollah says three of its members were killed in Israeli airstrikes in northeast Lebanon. Israel says its aircraft attacked Hezbollah in response to a rocket attack. The Iran-backed group in turn claims to have launched dozens more rockets at an Israeli border town. One man's reported to have died as a result.
Fox's Jonathan Savage. A controversial Texas border law remains blocked by an appeals court ruling this morning.
Texas Senate Bill 4 would make it a crime to cross the Texas-Mexico border between points of entry. It allows police to question and arrest anyone believed to have entered Texas through Mexico illegally who does not have immigration status. The Department of Justice says the law runs afoul of the federal government's authority over immigration and will lead to racial profiling.
Fox's Tanya J. Powers. Somebody's life changed overnight in New Jersey, winning a fortune. The $1.1 billion Mega Millions jackpot, the eighth largest U.S. lottery prize of all time. America's listening to Fox News.
Don't let everyday aches and pains keep you from living your best life.
I don't think I really understood what people meant when they talked about pain until I started feeling it myself.
Start feeling better every day with Relief Factor, a daily supplement designed to support your body's fight against aches and pains.
Not only do I move better without pain, I just feel better.
Created by doctors, Relief Factor uses a unique formula of natural ingredients that target four metabolic pathways to address pain. Relief Factor doesn't just mask aches and pains, it helps reduce or even eliminate them.
Today, I do the things I love, and it doesn't occur to me to think about pain.
You can feel the difference all day, every day.
Join the over 1 million people who have tried Relief Factor's 3-week quick start kit. It's only $19.95. Visit relieffactor.com or call 1-800-4-RELIEF. That's 1-800, the number 4-RELIEF. And feel the difference of Relief Factor.
What will the Supreme Court do this time? We may not find out until June, when it rules on the next big abortion case, a challenge to the FDA's approval of an abortion pill now more commonly used.
The Alliance for Hippocratic Medicine sued the FDA, saying their rule changes making it easier to get abortion drug mifepristone violated the law. But Supreme Court justices like Elena Kagan heavily questioned the group's attorney Aaron Hawley about whether the group even had standing or proper legal cause to sue. Hawley said, yeah, one client, a doctor, had to perform a procedure on a woman after she'd taken mifepristone.
She herself performed that.
That is correct,
Your Honor. And did she have an opportunity to object? Did she object?
No, Your Honor. Again, these are life-threatening situations.
The Biden administration's solicitor general argued the real harm here would be to the drug approval process and women if the justices do not side with the FDA. Jessica Rosenthal, Fox News.
That last big Supreme Court abortion ruling gave states the right to ban abortions, which President Biden brought up campaigning in North Carolina.
Trump proudly says, quote, after 50 years with no one coming close, I was able to kill Roe v. Wade. That's his statement. You've seen it on television.
Now, former President Trump keeps claiming Democrats are trying to undermine his campaign. with indictments and legal issues he calls election interference. In New York, less than 3 weeks before his first criminal trial is supposed to start, Judge Juan Merchan issued a gag order forbidding Trump comments about witnesses in the case or prosecutors or court staff or their families. The Trump campaign calls that unconstitutionally blocking his free speech rights. Republican Senator Ted Cruz blames the Manhattan District Attorney, telling Fox,
"This is Alvin Bragg, who's the Democrat DA, is a George Soros DA. He was elected with millions from George Soros, and this is a partisan abuse of power."
On Wall Street, stocks could rise this morning after recent selling. Dow futures up more than 100 points. I'm Dave Anthony. This is Fox News.
Good morning, WIBX 950 News Time, 8:05. I'm Andrew Dominio. This update brought to you by Adirondack Home Furniture. We have mostly cloudy skies, 41 degrees outside Studio B. Your full weather forecast is coming up. A 22-year-old woman from Herkimer County has pleaded guilty to murder. Herkimer County court officials say Taylor Goodhines of Mohawk entered a guilty plea before Judge Crandall to one count of second-degree murder. Police say Goodhines stabbed another woman identified as Takaya LaPlante, who was a mother of three, to death. Goodhines originally pleaded not guilty to second-degree murder and criminal possession of a weapon when she was arraigned in April of 2023, and she remained in jail without bail until her next trial. Goodhines will be sentenced on May 20th. Utica police arrested two people on felony drug charges. Authorities say they executed a search warrant at an apartment complex on Herkimer Road at Humphrey Gardens on March 22nd, following complaints of narcotics trafficking at the residence. Police say they found enough cocaine to warrant felony charges, along with packaging, scales, and a sum of cash. Police arrested 21-year-old Nazir Maynard and 25-year-old Ruby Civignoli, both from Utica, and charged them with two counts of third degree and one count of seventh degree criminal possession of a controlled substance. They were also charged with two counts of criminal use of drug paraphernalia. A million-dollar grant has been secured to construct a centralized Emergency Operation Medical and Fire Center, or an EOC, in the city of Utica. Senators Chuck Schumer and Kirsten Gillibrand celebrated the $1.2 million funding, which will consolidate firefighters and paramedics at Station 7 and enhance safety measures in the area. The construction will be centrally located on Oneida Square, which grants first responders easy access to the thruway, which will allow for rapid deployment of first responders. The EOC will also assist in coordination efforts with city police, relevant agencies, and social services. Rome police arrested an Annsville man on grand larceny charges stemming from an incident at the Rome Lowe's Improvement Store. Authorities say Daniel Cook stole roughly $8,575 in property from the store between December 9th of 2023 to February 14th of 2024. Police allege Cook would use the self-checkout lane and scan items of lesser value to steal the more expensive items. He was charged with grand larceny and with falsifying business records. He's since been released on his own recognizance. New York State's move over law is seeing a major change go into effect today. Drivers are now required to slow down and move over to avoid colliding with all vehicles that are stopped along a roadway, not just emergency vehicles. The goal is to prevent travelers, pedestrians, highway workers, and first responders from being injured. The law has been in place since 2010, and data shows that nationally, nearly 300 people are struck and killed roadside each year. Finally, a woman from California is now a NASA astronaut. Denise Burnham survived a pool of more than 12,000 applicants. And just this month, NASA moved her into the final pool. UC San Diego is announcing the newly minted astronaut with praise, saying Burnham earned a bachelor's degree in chemical engineering at the University of California, San Diego Jacobs School of Engineering. It is 8:08. Your weather forecast is brought to you by the new Destination Kia of Utica on Commercial Drive in Yorkville.
I'm Eyewitness News Chief Meteorologist Craig Flint in the WIBX Weather Center. Today, partly to mostly cloudy sky, milder, a few showers early, and then again later in the afternoon, a high near 60. Tonight, mostly cloudy, breezy with showers, a low of 37. And tomorrow, breezy, cooler, a few lingering showers early, then decreasing clouds, not as mild, a high near 50. For more on your local forecast, tune to Eyewitness News at 6 on WTR. I'm Meteorologist Craig Flint, WIBX 950 and 106.9 FM.
41 degrees under cloudy skies at 8:09. Sports brought to you by IBEW NECA 43 local contractors. A busy week in Orlando is leading to more changes for the upcoming NFL season. Teams are allowed to make deals 1 week later in the season, with the official deadline taking place on the Tuesday after week 9. Meanwhile, replay can now be used for intentional grounding, roughing the passer, and out-of-bounds hit penalties. Changes to kickoffs and a ban on hip drop tackles have already been approved at the meetings, which wrap up today. NFL fans will be getting a doubleheader for Christmas this year. The league announced on Tuesday that two games will be played on Christmas Day, despite the holiday landing on a Wednesday, which is not a traditional game day for the NFL. Commissioner Roger Goodell said they don't anticipate any player health concerns due to the teams playing on a short week. He added that the Wednesday games won't be a regular thing, and it will only be when Christmas lands on a Wednesday. The Diamondbacks are adding another experienced starting pitcher to their rotation. ESPN reports that Arizona is signing left-hander Jordan Montgomery to a one-year $25 million contract. The deal includes a vesting player option for 2025. In the NHL, the Rangers have clinched a spot in the Stanley Cup playoffs. The Blue Shirts guaranteed their spot in the postseason after topping the Flyers 6-5 in overtime at MSG. They are leading the Metro Division with 100 points at 48-20-4 and will visit the Colorado Avalanche tomorrow night. Meanwhile, the Islanders are hoping to put an end to their recent skid and get back into the hunt for the playoffs. They'll play the Florida Panthers at Amerant Bank Arena in Sunrise tomorrow. They are currently 30-26-15, making it 6 points shy of the second wild card. The New York Knicks are seeking their third win in a row. They're in the north in Toronto to take on the Raptors at Scotiabank Arena tonight. They're fourth in the Eastern Conference at 43-28. And the start of the 2024 Major League Baseball regular season is right around the corner, literally. Opening day is tomorrow, and the Mets will begin the season at home when they host the Milwaukee Brewers. Veteran left-hander Jose Quintana is expected to get the start for the Mets, while the Yankees will have lefty Nestor Cortes open up the season on the road as they visit the Houston Astros. And DJ LeMahieu will be starting the season on the DL, so not a great start for the Yankees. When it comes to injuries, it is 8-12.
All right. If you're watching on YouTube, I'm going to put up pictures of our new studio. So this is where it is right now. And, you know, just the technical things that we're going to be able to do, the problems we had on a regular basis, especially towards the last couple of years, all of that will be gone. Obviously, it'll create new issues. We have to get to learn how to use the equipment. So chances are it might be a little tricky when we move back into the studio at some point next week. But coming up, I'm gonna feature some photos up on YouTube that will show you the new studio when we move out of Studio B for basement.
It's looking pretty good. I've been in the building a couple of times. It's looking really nice.
There are some also interesting features that we'll tell you about. We'll get to all of it coming right up. I'll put those pictures up on YouTube. If you want to join in on YouTube and see what the pictures look like, you could do so on your big screen TV. Just look for your YouTube app, not YouTube TV, but your YouTube app, and search Keeler Live Stream. Like it, and it'll remind you that it's on every morning that it's on. It'll be easy to get to. You can watch on your phone. You could go on your computer. However you want to do it, use the YouTube app or YouTube.com in order to get there. Just search Keeler Live Stream. Give me 3 minutes, and I'll put those pictures right up on WIBX.
Rentals available exclusively at Ava Tulo's, the pinnacle of style in the Mohawk Valley. Ava Tulo's boasts a vast inventory of in-house rentals, ensuring that your attire is readily available without any delays. No more waiting for shipments from far-off warehouses. Everything's right there, waiting for you to touch, feel, and try on. Step into Ava Tulo's, nestled in the heart of the New Hartford Shopping Center, and let them help you create memories that will last a lifetime.
In the past 5 presidential election years, gold rose an average of 10%. This election year, where do you purchase gold for your portfolio? Don't believe the hype from the paid celebrities. Call me, America's Gold expert, Dr. Mike Fulgence at Universal Coin and Bullion. I've advised attorney generals and the FTC on protections for you, the consumer, and I won't add ridiculous markups so you won't overpay for gold. Call Universal Coin and Bullion at 800-822-GOLD. That's 800-822-GOLD, 800-822-GOLD.
Buckle up at Steep Pawnee Chevrolet in Herkimer, because it's truck season. They've got over 50 Silverados in stock and more on the way. Get behind the wheel of a brand new 2024 Silverado 1500 Crew Cab LT 4x4. Lease it for 3 years at 10,000 miles per year for just $498 a month. Or purchase with interest rates as low as 1.9% and get $5,250 in rebates. Need a heavy-duty truck? They've got a huge selection of three-quarter and one-ton trucks for work or play. They have the truck that fits your needs. Together, let's drive. Stop in and see why it's always easy to do business at Steep Pawnee Chevrolet, Route 28 in Herkimer, or online at steeppawneechevy.com.
For lease and financing offers, customers must qualify for top-tier credit through GM Financial. Offer on select models must have a 2010 or newer trade-in and a current lease and household for lease offer. All taxes, fees, and first payment due on delivery. See salesperson for details. Must take delivery by March 31st, 2024.
Scott and Jill here from New York Sash. I love springtime. Just look around. The street sweepers are out. The baseball fields are getting prepped.
It's time to tackle those spring projects around the house. And right now, for 1 week only, you can save big on windows, doors, and siding with New York Sash.
We have several new siding styles, including beautiful engineered wood, reinforced vinyl siding, and classic vinyl in 40 colors. And with our new 3D design tool, you can see what new siding will look like on your home.
So let's get to the special offers. For siding, the first 10 customers this week will receive free installation.
For windows, it's 20% off. New York Sash brand windows will make life so much easier.
And 20% off all doors, patio doors, entry doors, even storm doors, any brand, any style.
We told you, it's the big spring sale, but it's this week only.
Get started today. Visit our showroom at 349 Oriskany Boulevard in Whitesboro or online at newyorksash.com.
Whatever happened to Tony Horton, the guy who created the revolutionary P90X?
2017, I was knocked down. A very rare type of shingles that went straight into my brain. My body was completely wasting away. I started researching everything related to building my muscle back again. That's when I learned about the potential of HMB plus vitamin D3 and what they can do when it comes to helping build new muscle.
So Tony developed high-impact protein by Power Life.
Just add one scoop of high-impact protein to a glass of water or your morning smoothie and enjoy the effects of that boss molecule and factory worker combination. Reshaping your body each and every day. More energy, burn more fat, and probably drop a few pounds along the way.
High Impact Protein by Power Life is a tasty once-a-day powder that comes in either whey or plant protein. Go to mypowerlife.com and use code MUSCLE to save 30%. Tony even offers a 90-day guarantee. Go to mypowerlife.com or text MUSCLE to 511-511. Text MUSCLE to 511-511 today.
All individuals are unique. Your results can and will vary. These statements have not been evaluated by the FDA. This product is not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease. Text fees may apply.
WIBX 950 online at WIBX950.com.
All right, so I had mentioned that we are in what we call Studio B. It's B for basement. So while they have been gutting the studios, and just to let you know that it's not just our studio, but and I think what they've done is they set up Frog, Big Frog, in a small little production studio.
They're in OUR right now.
Oh, they're in OUR.
Frog's in OUR in Light 98.7, broadcasting from the Eagle studio.
Okay.
So they'll redo those studios once everything's back to normal.
Right. Are those getting done over too?
Right, yes they
are. Oh, I didn't know that. So they're doing the, because I think we have a syndicated show on OUR, right?
Yeah, Free Beer and Hot Wings. Yeah.
Well, when we're back in the studio, we'll have to... they're still doing the work, which I imagine they will. We'll have to interview Kelly, our mastermind of the studio design.
So I want to, if you're looking at YouTube right now, see the mixer right there. That's all. Those are computer screens. That's a virtual mixer, and it's all touch. It's all touch screen. That's going to be kind of cool. See the green light? You can see it right now on YouTube. That green light, I believe. There are lights that go off. So there'll be a light when a mic is live.
Yep.
There'll be a light when we're on the air, and there'll be a light if there was a problem. A red light would come on if we went off the air for any reason.
Which is a kind of opposite of what traditionally are the color indicators. Usually red means on the air, and then there's a light for when a phone call's coming in.
Right, you are correct.
So all those phone calls, it'll be a completely different phone system that we're using. And I normally don't get into this because people really care. But I think we've been so there have been so many problems in our studio. We've had so many technical problems in the lab. Like, everything was just falling to pieces that people who listen regularly know what we've been going through, and I think our
this will be fixed.
Yeah. Although, I'm going to tell you right now, I've gotten to be very comfortable here in Studio B.
Well, I know that we're playing all the commercials we have to in Studio B.
that we are. I'm going to give you one more shot at this if you're just tuning in on YouTube. I'll give you one more so you can see the studio. It looks kind of plain right now, and it will be generally plain, but you want everything to work. And it'll be comfortable for a guest coming in the studio. It'll be comfortable for... there's this other thing, too, that when we do go remotely, we just take a computer along, and everything can be run from the remote site. So I'm excited about that. So there it is. It's up on YouTube. Feel free to check it out. Search, if you go to YouTube, search Keeler Livestream, and it'll pop right up for you every morning once you get there. Okay? Fair enough. What are we talking about next? What's the,
so
what
this
are we doing?
Is, Shelly. Her name is Shelly Armato, and she is the CEO of My Smart Plans, which is a certified women-owned business that works to make the construction industry more efficient.
My Smart Plans.
Yes, she's managed over $12 billion in construction projects and has become a leading voice for the transparency in construction. And we're talking to her today about the bridge and what may have caused it to collapse and that tragedy that hit Baltimore just over a day ago.
Shelly, good morning.
Good morning.
This obviously could have been much, much worse. Had they not stopped cars from going over that bridge.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So think of the bridge. Oh, go ahead. I'm sorry.
No, go ahead. Go ahead.
No, I was just thinking of the other bridge that fell. Was it in Michigan that all the people were on the bridge and it just fell? We never really heard what really happened. It just it fell. It killed how many people?
So in 1987, I remember this well, although that was a long time ago. Their bridge collapsed in the New York State Thruway in upstate New York, and it was right around Amsterdam where it occurred. And that bridge is still there. It's been repaired. But if you stop and just look down, I don't know, it's a couple football fields down, maybe one at least. It's a long drop. It was during flooding in the springtime, heavy rain, and the bridge just got washed out. And imagine in upstate New York on the New York State Thruway, nobody there. I mean, it took passersby. It took people realizing what had happened to stop their vehicles, get out of their car, and wave people down to prevent them from literally
driving off the cliff.
Driving off the cliff into the water. And I think, I don't know, maybe four or five cars went down there. All of those people perished in that. And it was just, you know. So these things can be horrible. Obviously, six people died on this situation. How does it happen? It shows you how vulnerable we are, Shelly. This takes some real planning, I would think, to make sure that we have ourselves covered when it comes to this sort of thing.
Well, from our perspective, so we are a disruptive construction technology, and our technology tracks, organizes, and archives all construction data, and the project runs audit ready. So when we hear about situations like this, our thoughts go directly to the retrieval of the data of the project, like what was on that bridge, like what kind of steel did they use, how was the steel, who were the workers that were on the project, what was the as-built on the project, all of the data that takes without us like countless days, hours, months to retrieve. This is the critical data that has to be available whenever something like this happens. It has to be a click of a button. Or if there's a fire and they walk into a building and the fire department's like, oh, my God, where's the layout of this building? That information should be in the knock box. And just like this project, there should be a digital library that they can go and be like, boom, these are the people that were on the project. Here's what they were repairing. Here's the kind of concrete they were using. Here's what time this happened. It's that time capsule that is so critical. And, I mean, we can speculate all day long about what really happened.
Yeah.
But what really happened is it's a tragedy. And we all want to resolve those kinds of things from happening to the best of our ability. So it's definitely causes sleepless nights for me.
Yeah. And it does show you how vulnerable we are around the country and how much of our infrastructure is vulnerable to possible terrorist attacks. Not that that's what this was, but, you know, it does make you think.
Yeah, there's a lot of speculation we can do, but whenever we have the data that's organized, the speculation's eliminated.
Sorry to cut you off, but you mentioned, you know, what keeps you up at night from the standpoint of who's going to be getting the call today or who got the call yesterday with regard to this? You know, is it somebody that worked on the project, somebody that was doing maintenance, original constructor? Who's the one that probably likely got a call yesterday?
Well, in the current situation of the infrastructure and all the construction that's going on, the biggest competition we have is the shredder. I mean, whoever was on that project, that data is gone because they do not want to be held accountable. So the real people on these projects are the people that are suffering. It's the, we always talk about the subcontractors that are trying to do the best of the job, but they don't have access to the data that's audit ready to make decisions. So it's across the board a crisis situation that we have stepped in 19 years ago and said, hey, can you imagine if this project ran audit ready and it was in the hands of a third party and you click a button, it's there, the information's organized and everyone gets to make the decision and everyone gets to be held accountable and there's a timestamp on who, what, when, and where. So that's the critical conversation. The bridge fell, that is critical. That is a terrible situation. But imagine if going forward, when they rebuilt the bridge, that they built that bridge with audit ready data and whatever concrete they use would be actually tracked and organized. They would know who poured the concrete, what time it was. Was it raining when they poured the concrete?
Yeah.
Because no one has that.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Best practices.
And you know, we had a our congressman was on earlier this morning, and he was in the Navy and was on a nuclear submarine, and talks about just some of the common practices. And what he said is out in San Diego, if you see the bridges, the supports that hold the bridge up, that they obviously the column comes down, it's concrete, but around it they've created a whole like a rock barrier so that if a ship were to go out of control, it would hit that barrier and not hit the actual support beam or the support pillar. And then somebody says here, Richard, there were two tugboats that led the ship on its way. People are saying there weren't any tugboats. There were. But after the ship got going, the tugs left. That's when the ship lost power and steering. One of the tugs turned around, but it was too late. He says he saw this on the news last night. So I guess we're going to see a lot of this stuff trickle out. But your point is, if we did our due diligence in the beginning, this stuff would be out there right off the bat.
Exactly. And you think they're going to come back in 6 months and say, oh, well, this is really what happened.
Yeah.
This is the contractor that was held responsible. This was who was driving the boat. This was, I mean, like, give us the facts. I'm like into the total fact thing. Like, tell me what happened and let me be able to do my research and know that this is exactly what happened.
Well, I mean.
Go ahead.
No, I was just going to say, a lot of our federal projects that we go to, we build a lot of airports, and I mean, we do bridges, roads, all those things. But two major airports in our country that we went and did our presentation and said, look, everyone gets fair play. We all get to be at the same table. Both places, one of them actually told us that we could not be hired because the mafia runs their projects. And the other one, literally, they say these things to you. And you're like, are you for real? I mean, like, are you telling me? Make up something like, I don't know, dog eats cat food. And then the other one, they said, well, we really don't want these contracts to be that accessible in case anyone does the sunshine law. And I was just like, I can't believe you're telling me this.
Right,
don't tell me. Just lie to my face about it. You know what I'm saying? Don't tell me that, because our company is in the forefront of the accountability and transparency and all the things that need to happen whenever a project is going. So anyway, we're hoping to write a Netflix series one day because it's almost the Aaron Brockovich story.
Yeah, it's very interesting.
Did
because
that really happen?
We rely, as a society, we rely on infrastructure. We rely that these bridges and buildings and decks and parking garages, we rely on officials holding the contractor responsible and knowing that we're the safest country in the world, we believe anyway, when it comes to construction and infrastructure. The real question is, what corners are we really cutting? Who's in danger and who's at fault?
Mm-hmm. Oh, and who's grifting?
Yeah.
Because the grift is real. But, I mean, I was just in the Pentagon last week, and the Department of Defense is going to be supporting mega projects on our platform. But it's just, there's just so much of, my cousin works there, you know, well, you know, he's a consultant for this and, you know, he does this. And it's like, whenever we're on the project, you know exactly what goes on.
Yeah,
I mean, you know the timestamp, you know, who poured the concrete, you know, who's doing the lighting package, you know, everything.
Yeah.
And what's wrong with that? I don't know. I'm confused why that would not be such a great thing for our country.
Who's your cousin, by the way?
My cousin Vinny.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
We might know him. We're from Utica. Anything else?
Yeah, I mean, just the last thing really is, you know, President Biden addressed the issue yesterday in an address and made a statement about it, you know, saying that the federal government will help pay for it in full, which, you know, is a noble idea. But where's the accountability on, you know, the insurance company of the driver of this boat, the company that crashed into the bridge, or like you said, maybe a contractor that didn't do what they were supposed to do in construction of the bridge? You know, why is it on the taxpayer, I guess?
Well, and that's the chronic problem that we have, is that the taxpayers are at the mercy. And whenever we start bringing accountability to the table and finding, well, I mean, I could go on like a whole show on, you've got to be kidding me, but It's the small business. It's the subcontractors that are trying to do their job and trying to be able to do what the contract requires, and it's a chronic problem.
Yeah.
And you know, we're at the forefront of this.
And the reality is, the federal government has to step up. This is way too of an important bridge and port to just let everybody figure things out. Afterwards, it would be nice to get some money back when it comes to penalties and fines and that sort of thing, if you find that rules were not followed and we find wrongdoing. So, you know, we got to figure out a way to get that thing back open, because it's a closed, that becomes a real problem. All right. Mm-hmm. Interesting stuff. Shelley Armato, what do women know about keeping things organized? I mean, really? Oh, wait a minute.
It'll be D
when you get
down with us. Yeah, seriously.
Okay.
All right, Shelley, thank you. Have a wonderful day.
Thank you.
All right. Thanks so much. I think she took me seriously about the what do women know.
Oh, yeah.
You know, the reality is, why not women? They seem to be make better decisions oftentimes, and they seem to be more organized. And they seem to be able to do three or four things at once and still make dinner for the guy who doesn't know how to cook, if that's the dynamic you live in. It is what it is, right? Got a break. Hold on tight. We'll talk to Ryan Nobles about this very same topic. He's been covering that. Also, Ryan, I definitely want to talk about the decision by NBC to unhire Rona McDaniel.
I think it's crazy.
Let's get the details on it and see what happened. But it is the wrong. You want opposing opinions on these shows. You want people who are from the other side. Fox needs strong liberals on their programming to be able to have a proper discourse, right? Back and forth. CNN, and they all need to do the same thing. But are we reaching a point now where NBC is like, well, our employees don't like this person's opinion, so we're not going to hire them?
And what does that do for their credibility? I mean, again, it's NBC News, but their credibility is a impartial news source.
So let's get the story from Ryan coming up in a few minutes. Ryan Nobles from NBC. It's 8:34 at WIBX.
That is Padula & Sons Roofing is your hometown roofers with deep roots in our community. Padula Roofers specialize in residential roofing projects. They're a GAF-certified Master Elite Roofing contractor who keeps their standards above the rest. Call 315-733-1564 to find out more about their Roofs for Troops mail-in rebate. That is Padula & Sons Roofing, your hometown roofers.
Keep your income tax return. You worked hard for it. At Mattress Express, we're not only going to pay the sales tax for you, but qualified customers get zero down and up to 5 years interest-free on select luxury king and queen sets like the Smart Bed by Instant Comfort, Posh and Lavish, and more.
Hi, I'm Henry Winkler. My eyes are very important to me. My eyes connect me with everything I love. I loved my late father-in-law dearly. He always lit up a room, but his vision dimmed with age. He had age-related macular degeneration, or AMD. And since partnering with Apellis, I've learned there's an advanced form of dry AMD called geographic atrophy, or GA. His struggle with vision loss made me want to help others know about GA's warning signs. For some, colors appear dull or washed out. For others, hazy or blurred vision make it hard to see details, like fine print on price tags. Many have trouble seeing in the dark, making driving at night difficult. GA gets worse over time and cannot be reversed. If you think you have GA, don't wait. Treatments are available. Ask a retina specialist about FDA-approved treatments for GA and go to gawon'twait.com.
This Saturday, the Rome Capitol Theater presents It's a Mad World. Here's what people are saying about the movie.
I got physically sick from laughing.
You enjoyed the picture then?
Oh, yes, I'm going to see it again just as soon as I get out of the hospital.
Brace yourselves for Stanley Kramer's It's a Mad, 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 Mad World.
Saturday at the Rome Capitol Theater at 1:30 and 6:45. For more details, visit RomeCapitol.com.
When you don't have enough to eat, all you think about is food. That makes it hard to give your best.
Nearly impossible to feel your best.
And it makes tough decisions even tougher.
At Food Bank of Central New York, all we think about is food too, and how to get it to the people who need it most. Think you can help? Give today at foodbankcny.org.
Hello?
Yes, calling from the telephone company. We're doing some repairs this morning on the lines.
Where, here?
Yes.
Why?
Well, we've got some line troubles. This is something we do. It's an annual cleanup. We're going to be blowing out the lines today.
Oh.
I just wanted to warn you that there could be some actual debris that comes out of the telephone when we blow these lines.
Oh.
So it might be an idea to put a Ziploc bag or a plastic bag around the mouthpiece of the phone to prevent any dust from getting around your kitchen area.
Oh.
All right. Do you have a bag right there? Can you get a plastic bag? Put it over the phone.
Yeah, I can get them. Well, are you going to start now?
We're going to do it as soon as you get the bag on the phone. Can you do it quickly?
Yeah.
I'll wait right here.
You want me to? All right. Hold on.
Okay.
I have three phones, so you're going
to
wait.
Yeah, I'll have to wait for all three of them.
All right.
Okay. Yes, you got
the... How long is this going to take?
It should only take about 30 seconds.
All right.
You got
go
the...
ahead.
Do you have the bag all... Bag... All right, man, we seem to be okay. Ma'am?
Yeah.
We seem to be all right now. You're all set.
Thank you.
We'll do it again next year. Goodbye.
Now back to Keeler.
Hello, I'd like to vote for president, governor, and anything that will take money away from our parks and libraries.
Go vote now. It'll make you feel big and strong. WIBX 950 and 106.9 FM. The Keeler Show.
Well, that's a little blast from the past right there. Wow. Wow. Boy, those lines were dusty. I got right into my right into my lungs, it felt like. All right, a couple things. The official coffee of the Keeler in the Morning radio program is from Daylight Donuts. We enjoy it here in Studio B.
I just poured myself a new cup.
We get the box of coffee. That's the way to do it. Espressos, lattes, iced coffee, breakfast sandwiches, bagels made fresh every day. Their donuts are made fresh every single day right there in New Hartford at Daylight Donuts. And the snowflake rolls. I got to call over there today and make sure I'm on the list. You got to reserve them for Sunday dinner, your Sunday Easter dinner. You must reserve them by calling 315-724-7103. I will reserve them. And I think we can take that. I don't know who that's going to be, but we can take that call if you want to figure that out. You can reserve the snowflake rolls by calling 315-724-7103. They are the best. River Hills Properties continues to be the fastest growing real estate company in Central New York. They are the number one independent real estate agency. And they have a brand new TV show coming out called Sold in Upstate New York. Sold in Upstate New York. Homes that are for sale, homes that have sold, tips on selling and buying. Andrew, this is going to be a really cool program.
Yeah, I'm very excited about it. And Bill and Robin have a good vision for it, guided by you. So
it'll be on Sundays.
Yeah, we're really excited.
On Fox 33 TV. So that's
the premiere is this Sunday.
Next Sunday.
Next Sunday.
Don't get ahead of yourself.
I don't want to make you nervous.
No, that would make me very nervous. What was that, Davey? Everything good?
Oh, that was Eric wanted to ask you, have you ask Ryan a question. How come the anchors weren't down on the tugboat, on the boat that hit the bridge yesterday?
How come the anchors weren't down? Yeah, he's actually, Ryan, I just spoken with, he's going to be a little late this morning, but he is going to call. We are going to get him, but he's doing an NBC hit, is what they call it, at 8:44. So right after that, must be on the Today Show. Right after that, we'll get them. Steve Pawnee Mazda, their new year, new Mazda sales event is back. Drive a new 2024 Mazda CX-30 sport model for only $297 a month on a 36-month lease. Or, as Rick says, come on in. You can save on a low APR financing, 0.9%, 1.9%, or 2.9% deal on select award-winning new 2024 Mazdas. See Steve Pawnee Mazda for details. Let's make your deal on a new Mazda where it's always easy to do business. Steve Pawnee Mazda Commercial Drive in Yorkville. All right. So other things that are going on beyond this this whole...
Well, there's a couple of things, really.
Well, there's a lot. What do you want to highlight on? And I've got stuff.
Well, we got stuff on the website, too, WIBX950.com. You can read about Sinatra's Pizzeria in Rome and Oneida. They are actually being forced to change their name. I'm working on getting the owner on the program possibly tomorrow morning to discuss it. But
I would wonder why. So Sinatra is trademarked?
The Sinatra Foundation and family have sent a very kind cease and desist. They've been very understanding and given them plenty of time to come up with a new name, but now it's time for
them
to make the change.
There was a place in the old Black Cat. Where that is over by Home Depot, where they, when you went in, they had all these pictures of celebrities on the menu.
Burrito Jones?
It was.
Yeah.
All that stuff, all it would take is for somebody to go there and realize that's trademarked, that's copyrighted, that you can't have. That place isn't around anymore, though, is it?
It's not.
Yeah. Those are big burritos, though.
Yeah, and the other big story, food-related-wise, local restaurant-wise, is the Krispy Kreme's coming to McDonald's.
And beyond that, Fryhoffer's has closed all of its locations. As Andrew said, NFL owners are approving huge changes to kickoffs. The kicker will be kicking the ball from the 35-yard line like normal. The kicker's teammates will line up on their opponent's 40-yard line. The receiving team will have 9 or 10 players lined up on their own 35-yard line. Kicks must land between the receiving team's 20-yard line and the goal line. That's interesting. Or it's a penalty? If it were to land...
This will be interesting, too, because you'll see probably a lot more return kickoffs.
Once the ball is fielded or hits the ground, players from both teams may begin play. A kick that either goes out of bounds or lands short of the 20-yard line will result in the receiving team getting the ball on their own 40. A kick that goes into the end zone will result in a touchback, and the receiving team will get the ball on their own 30-yard line. I'm sure we'll hear a lot of that about that coming up. Guess who's talking about Ohtani's gambling scandal?
Oh, yeah. You know he is.
Pete Rose, in a video posted on Instagram, is out with all the gambling-related drama. Pete Rose thought the whole thing needed his comment. The hit king slash gambling fan and, sadly, non-Hall of Fame inductee says, well, back in the 70s and 80s, I wish I had an interpreter. I'd be scot-free, because he would have said, I didn't do it. I didn't know anything about it.
I had a friend of mine make the, you know, was making the bets, and I had to pay his debts off.
Although I will say that Davey said, you watched the interview. You believe Ohtani.
I do believe Ohtani.
Yeah, you think he's telling the truth.
I guess, well, and here's the thing. You know, Michael Jordan is very, it's very well known that he had a habit of gambling. He enjoyed it very much. So, you know, my thought originally was, well, he's a professional athlete. What does he need to gamble for? He's making a ton of money as it is, but look at Jordan.
A woman accused of scams, saying she was an heiress, a witch, and psychic. Marianne Smith has been arrested in Maine, is awaiting a hearing to determine if she'll be extradited back to the U.K. for a scam that dates back a decade and a half ago. Between 2008 and 2010, she allegedly stole more than $170,000 from at least five victims. She claimed she had all of this going on. She was an heiress, she was a witch, she was a psychic, and she was able to con people out of cash. Now she may be in trouble. We all know about the solar eclipse coming a week from Friday, but how much do you know about the upcoming stoner eclipse?
Stoner, we'll have to get J-Man on to talk
this
about that.
This year, the date is April 20th, 420, meaning that it looks, it's a palindrome, meaning that it looks the same way backwards as it does forwards. Are you ready? 4-20-24. And if you go backwards, 4-2-0-2-4 versus forwards, 4-2-0-2-4. This is being portrayed as a massive event in stoner culture, as it will not happen again until April 20th, 3024.
Wow. Oh, yeah, 420 backwards.
So we will not be around for that.
People are going to sleep through it. The major stoners are just going to sleep right
yeah,
through it.
Yeah, if there's a world left.
Yeah, right.
Do you wonder, will there be a world left?
Oh, God, yes.
Al Gore says no, there will not be. I wonder if we'll just destroy everything by the time we get to there. We'd kind of wonder, right? Kind of have to wonder. Just
I think we'll be long
bit.
Gone before that happens.
The good news is we will be long gone before that actually ever happens. We talked a lot about the bridge. We'll get into more of that with Ryan Nobles when we do get him, and it looks like we're grabbing him right now. Can you handle that? Let me take a quick break, and I'll take Ryan next on WIBX.
Exciting news. We are expanding with a couple of new offices in our area. One new location is North Country Estates Insurance in Lowellville. They are another independent insurance agency that takes pride in making customers happy and fits our culture at Gates Cole perfectly. Here is William Schaub from the newest Gates Cole agency, North Country Estates Insurance in Lowellville.
Working with us as an independent agent with this many companies, we will often call our clients and say, we're going to reduce your premium if you like. We have the companies that do well in New York and specifically this area. The coverages that we provide are commercial and personal insurance. That's the home, the auto, ATV, motorcycle. There's nothing more fun than taking care of a customer and being able to tell them that we're able to save them some money.
Proudly representing Finger Lakes Fire and Casualty Company of Trumansburg, New York. Gates Cole Insurance. We'll take care of you.
FM. This is Keeler.
And we're back. And we're back.
Yes, we are. And John in New Hartford.
It is 8:49. What?
John in New Hartford says, for many gamblers, it's not about the money, it's about the adrenaline rush. But a lot of times it's about the money.
Yeah.
Go jump out of a plane with a parachute if you want to get an adrenaline rush.
It's about the money when you lose a lot, I would imagine.
Yeah.
Right? On the line right now is the one and only Ryan Nobles from NBC. Ryan, good morning.
Hey, Bill. Good morning. How are you?
Good. I know you're out in Baltimore. What do we know? Anything new this morning?
Yeah, actually, as I'm talking to you, I'm staring right at the bridge and that massive container ship that smashed into it. You really can't wrap your mind around it when you're looking at it, especially if you've ever been to Baltimore and you've driven over the Key Bridge, which I've done many times.
Yeah.
The idea that it could just be sitting in the water right now, completely collapsed, is hard to kind of comprehend. Probably the most important news that developed overnight is that this has moved from a rescue mission to a recovery mission. Which means that the six people that are missing are now presumed to be dead. And man, you know, they're very committed to finding their remains, but that is going to be a very difficult task.
Yeah,
I mean, just for, you know, where I'm standing right now, you know, I can see into the river, and you can't see anything. So imagine it being in the middle of the river as a diver trying to get in there, and the footprint where these bodies could have gone is just massive. And there's a huge current underneath the river. There's all kinds of complications, and the river's just absolutely freezing. You know, temperatures
right.
A lot of times like in the 40s. So this is going to be a massive effort, and that's the recovery effort. And after that, the recovery effort's going to be very long as well.
Well, especially just trying to get all that debris out of the water, too. I mean, it's going to take massive tools and ships and things like that to do it.
Yeah, I mean, and, you know, they can't even really begin that process until they believe that the recovery process has run its course.
Yeah.
And so, you know, they're being very careful of that. And then the other thing, too, with the removal of all the debris is that the NTSB views that as evidence, right? So what they'll likely do is when they get the equipment in here necessary to actually start taking the bridge apart, they will kind of handle it very delicately so that they can recreate the bridge in a different location and kind of go piece by piece to try and figure out why it collapsed so quickly, you know, what led the bridge to kind of careen in that direction to ultimately, you know, crash into the bridge and have it fall down. So, you know, it's not just as simple as just picking everything up and getting it out of here. It's a very meticulous effort. So, you know, there's any range of estimates as to how long it'll be before the harbor is back open. You know, it could be a couple of weeks, could be months before it's done. And this is a huge, huge port in terms of getting goods in and out of the United States. What's interesting about this particular port is that it's the easternmost port, it's the westernmost port. So it's the furthest the port on the East Coast, and that's within a day's drive to a third of the country. So you have to imagine from a shipping perspective how valuable that location is.
Wow. Now, wow. Ryan, has there been any word from authorities on the driver of the operator? I know it's usually computers that are navigating a ship of that size, but the operators of that vessel?
No, so that's part of the investigation, and the NTSB said this morning that they have recovered the recording box inside the vessel, and it's actually kind of, as I'm staring at it right now, it's kind of remarkable that the ship itself has actually, you know, in comparison to the bridge, really did not sustain that much damage. Every person on board the ship is still, was accounted for. The ship's not in any danger of sinking. Every single one of the containers is actually still on the ship. None of them even came close to falling off. So the way this works is in a harbor like this, because it is such a narrow stretch, there's two pilots on the ship, and one of them is a local pilot whose only job is to take these big, massive cargo ships in and out of the harbor, and then they hand it off to the pilot that will then take it across the ocean. And this particular ship was heading to Sri Lanka. So it was likely a local pilot that was kind of running the ship at the time. The question is what went wrong with the ship.
Yeah.
And the Wall Street Journal is reporting this morning that maybe there was some bad fuel that was put into the ship that led it to lose power. There's a bunch of theories that are happening right now, but they're at such an early stage in this investigation that there's a lot of work that still needs to be done.
All right, so I'm assuming you'll be covering this through the day and then into tonight for the nightly news as well from Baltimore.
Well, I'm going to be on the MSNBC here in the next couple minutes. So
okay, before you go there, I did want to ask about this the situation with Rona McDaniel. is there something?
You sure?
What is there something you know? I mean, that you can
something
tell?
You don't want to touch with a 10-foot pole.
I really don't have any special insight into it. The decision was made well above my pay grade. The only thing I'll say about it is, I think mistakes were made. I think everyone in the companies acknowledged that. But I think the goal here was admirable, right? We're trying to get as many unique voices on the air that demonstrate the pulse of the country.
Yeah.
But we're in a weird time now where, the wide range of voices can lead to trouble. And in terms of this decision-making process, I don't really know enough about it to comment about it in a cogent way. But I do think there is something important to be said about trying to get as many people and to get the perspective of as many Americans as possible. So this didn't work out, but maybe we'll have better ways to do it in the future.
Maybe Newt Gingrich wants to join in. he might be a good one.
Oh, Bill.
All right. Well, listen, you have a very important task ahead
here
of you.
Going to cover a major breaking news story would keep me from having to answer these questions.
I'm so sorry.
But you did a good job letting us know about that info.
I would not be doing my job if I didn't at least bring it up. So
I understand.
Have it. All right, okay. Ryan, you have a wonderful
day. Send hate mail to Bill.
Watching tonight with Lester Holt on NBC Nightly News. Thank you.
All right. Thanks, guys.
Okay. All right. Ryan Nobles from NBC. And you listen. You understand? Don't hold it against. You're not going to be able to be. Well, I think management really made a big mistake.
Screwed the pooch. Yeah, yeah.
So, but the reality is, I will tell you, there's something to be said for depending on who you are. Now, if you're somebody who just likes to fight with people, having an opposing side around is fun. But if you're someone who doesn't like to fight and wants to talk to people who agree with you.
Like-minded, yeah.
Getting those like-minded people together can be equally as fun because you just have a field day, right? No matter what side
you're
on. But what I find interesting, though, is this is the world we're in right now. It does worry me because I think it is so important. And, let me tell you. Well, Fox News brings on liberals. Yes. Liberals who are easy to beat up, that's what they bring on. You're not going to bring somebody on that's going to embarrass you. And all of the networks are guilty of this. I still believe that you can watch your nightly news, no matter what the network, and the news department at Fox, the news department at ABC, CBS, NBC, they still remain, I think, journalists. And I it's hard to find that today. But I still think it exists, just my opinion. I can also tell you the greatest place in the world to get your flooring is in Sarah's Flooring Outlet. They have the largest inventory anywhere. In sarahsflooringoutlet.com, get 6 months interest-free financing. Route 49 Plaza, River Road in Marcy.
He moved them, Sarah.
Oh, he moved them?
Yeah, yeah, I thought he was going
long. Oh, you guys got to tell me you're doing this. For God's sake.
We had to be out of 5750 and you were going past.
Just keep hitting the button and nothing is happening. Well, let me tell you about Sarah's Flooring Outlet. I can be a little more in depth. They have the price guarantee on Pergo Extreme. Within a 60-mile radius, you're guaranteed to get the best price. Period. It's in Sarah's Flooring Outlet. Sal and everybody over there at Sarah's will take you and really, really take care of you. And what I like, too, is you can go and get tile or unique products that you've probably never even seen before, and it might be unique to your home, which is something very special as well. All right. Take a deep breath here. Andrew, you have a very big day on the way today.
I do. We'll be interviewing for a new listing, a big one in the Clinton area, so hopefully that will be successful. I presume it will be.
Some comments here this morning. Lance, Bill, why hasn't the redhead been on the show? That would be an interesting day. Well, with HIPAA regulations, we probably can't even talk about it, but I would say that she's been out sick.
Yes.
For a couple of weeks. She's doing much better, and she's still working from home, but that's about all we can say about it and all of that. If you're just tuning in now and you maybe are going to go back and listen or watch on the YouTube channel, right around, what time was it? 8 o'clock?
Yeah, right after the 8 o'clock
Right after the 8 o'clock news, we showed pictures of the new studio if you want to check that out. Just search Keeler Livestream up there on YouTube. And are you dropping the ID, too? Oh, okay. Got to go. Back tomorrow.
IDI Utica Rome, your news, talk, and sports leader, a Town Square media station.
Haven't found six bridge collapse victims in Baltimore. I'm Dave Anthony, Fox News. They are presumed dead now.
I spent a good part of yesterday with the families, praying with them, praying for them, and praying for their peace.
Maryland Governor Wes Moore just told Fox divers will keep working to find the construction workers in a recovery mission, but it'll take a long time to rebuild the bridge.
The economic impact that this is having, not just on the state of Maryland, but on the entire country, is staggering. We're talking about a port that's responsible for over 51 million tons of foreign cargo. That's the largest in the country.
The National Transportation Safety Board has the voyage data recorder from the cargo ship that crashed into the bridge, trying to determine what went wrong and why. Texas's controversial border law remains blocked. A federal appeals court extended its hold on the law as the federal government calls it an overreach into immigration authority. Texas's Republican governor says they have the right to stop an invasion, with a law allowing police to arrest migrants who cross the border illegally. The Trump campaign's angry. A judge in New York City issued a gag order before the former president's first criminal trial, claiming it unconstitutionally blocks his free speech rights.
He's not allowed to make public statements about witnesses, court staff, jurors, and others in his case, with an upcoming trial date set for April 15th. The former president's charged with filing false business records when he reimbursed his then-personal attorney for hush money payments to an adult film star who alleged an affair.
Fox's Jessica Rosenthal and other Republicans been taken off the air. NBC News is dropping Ronald McDaniel days after hiring the former Republican National Committee chair, which upset MSNBC viewers and hosts.
Many anchors sounding off in lockstep, including President Biden's former press secretary.
This is about truth versus lies.
Jen Psaki also warned democracy was in danger after McDaniel was hired. The chairman of NBC Universal issued a mea culpa while announcing the termination of McDaniel. Quote, no organization, particularly a newsroom, can succeed unless it is a cohesive and aligned.
That's Fox's Lucas Tomlinson. America's listening to Fox News.
Don't let everyday aches and pains keep you from living your best life.
I don't think I really understood what people meant when they talked about pain, until I started feeling it myself.
Start feeling better every day with Relief Factor, a daily supplement designed to support your body's fight against aches and pains.
Not only do I move better without pain, I just feel better.
Created by doctors, Relief Factor uses a unique formula of natural ingredients that target four metabolic pathways.